Monday night in Toronto, Tampa Bay's reckless play may have left Toronto shaken, but the Lightning took the loss and tonight seek a win in facing the Red Wings here in Detroit. As Sunshine Network presents NHL Tampa Bay Lightning Hockey, as we welcome you to Detroit, a city with great tradition, as the Lightning pay a call on their Norris Division rivals. Ah, the great names through the years. Terrible Ted Lindsay, Alex Delvecchio, Gordie Howe, number 9. As these two Norris Division teams have at it, in the home of a franchise that really earned its name from James Norris 60 years ago, who the division is now named after. As we say hello and welcome you to our studios on Sunshine Network, I'm Paul Kennedy, your host this evening. Two teams who need a win in Detroit and Tampa Bay square off, and two teams whose rosters now both are graced by All-Stars. Brian Bradley named to the All-Star team earlier this week, and of course, Stevie Yzerman will be skating in his 7th All-Star game in February for Detroit, and for the first time in his career, Steve Chazen will earn that same All-Star distinction for the Red Wings. A lot to talk about tonight between these two teams. Let's go right away to NHL headlines. And as you know, if you follow the NHL, Mario Lemieux has been diagnosed as suffering from Hodgkin's disease. Following a biopsy, Mario to undergo radiation treatments. And while he has a high probability of a full recovery, he will be out at least 2 months. And while he will not play in the All-Star game, Wayne Gretzky will, by presidential appointment, the great one, despite missing most of this season and last, will add to the glitter in Montreal in February. Last night around the NHL, Joe Giugno earns the hat trick as Boston beats the Sabres. Eddie Belfour in goal for Chicago to master Minnesota. L.A. rallying from a 2-goal deficit to win one over Ottawa. And New Jersey scores a pair in the final 10 minutes to conquer the Canucks. Elsewhere, Calgary falling for the 5th straight time. 3 separate Devils earning a pair of goals. Malakoff, Lachance, and Frazier. And Winnipeg jets past San Jose 4-1. Zamnoff with 2 goals for the winning Winnipeg Jets. The Norris standings with Chicago firmly in first place. And Detroit having risen to 49 points at 23-19-3. With Tampa Bay, as you see, with 32 points on the season. To the Smythe. Vancouver atop the division, Calgary stumbling, and the Kings on the rise with Gretzky back. From the Campbell to the Whales and in the Adams, the Habs and the Nords in a season-long battle for first place, and you see Boston and Buffalo with playoff berths all but assured. To the Patrick, and led by the Pens and the Washington Capitals, who will skate in Expo Hall Sunday night, 2 points ahead of the Rangers. The reception Saturday night should be tumultuous for this man, Brian Bradley, as his team returns home to face St. Louis. Brian earning a place in sports history, the first man ever to wear a Lightning sweater and appear in an All-Star game. He scored his 32nd in Toronto a couple of nights ago. While Mark Bureau was picking up a shorthanded goal, his 7th of the year, but Mark unfortunately injured the sartorius muscle, which wraps from your hip to your knee, and this solid two-way player will be out this evening. Shane Stevenson, the right winger, a welcome newcomer to the Lightning Club since his recall from Atlanta last week, is in uniform tonight. He has played the past 2 seasons sporadically for the Boston Bruins before being selected by the Lightning in the expansion draft. Detroit's all-star and captain, like Brian Bradley, he wears number 19, and Stevie Yzerman is ready for play again tonight. 31 goals and 60 points to lead the Red Wings. He has appeared in 6 All-Star games to date. And defenseman Steve Chazen will also appear in the All-Star Classic, as we mentioned, in Montreal. He becomes the first Detroit defenseman in 10 years to earn that honor. So here is Tampa Bay ending a rather long 9-game road trip with an opportunity to do so on a high note by upending powerful Detroit. And in just a moment, we will visit with Brian Bradley to talk about this evening's game, as well as Mark Howe, and we'll hear from the Lightning head coach and Terry Crisp, and John Kelly and Danny Gare will join us as well in our studios. And as we set sail from Detroit, here are all the other games set for play tonight in the National Hockey League. And Brian Bradley is next from the Joe Louis Arena, the home of the Red Wings, here in Detroit, on Sunshine Network. night filled with all-stars here in the Joe Louis Arena. The Tampa Bay Lightning skating against the Detroit Red Wings as we welcome you inside the Joe. And it's a pleasure for all of us at Sunshine Network to congratulate Tampa Bay's first all-star, Brian Bradley. Brian, quite an honor.
Yeah, you know, I'm definitely thrilled about the whole thing right now. It's I haven't really caught all the hype yet, but, you know, I will once the time comes.
It was ironic, perhaps, that you got word of this in Toronto. The team that didn't protect you, and two nights ago you scored a goal on the very day you were named to the NHL All-Star team.
Well, you know, it was a big thrill, you know, playing against Toronto and getting named in there. And, you know, when the time comes, like when I have to go to the All-Star game in Montreal, it'll be very exciting for me. But right now, I think we have to focus on tonight's game against Detroit.
Let's focus first on the fact that this season goes all the way to April. You have 32 goals in the bank right now. You're only 18 shy of 50. That's not outside the realm of possibility.
Well, you know, it you know, definitely isn't. I've been scoring lately quite a lot, and you know, I'm just taking each game at a time. And like I said, some games you you know, you just work hard as you can. Some games go your way and some don't, but as long as you give the effort, you know, things will go my way.
About 10 days ago, the Lightning enjoyed the returned services of Basil McRae, the winger. He was put on your line. Has that helped you?
Well, definitely. You know, Basil is known throughout the league as a tough guy, and not only can Basil play tough, but he's very good with the puck, and he's smart. He goes out there and he intimidates other players, and, you know, he knows what to do, and it's definitely opened a lot of room up for myself and for John Tucker, and, you know, we get a lot more room to freewheel.
Tonight, you're facing a team that loves to hit, loves to check in Detroit. Let's talk about the Red Wings.
Well, definitely not. Besides checking and hitting, I think the Red Wings are big on scoring. In tonight's game, we have to definitely concentrate on keeping the score to a 2-1 or 3-2 game. Anytime we get into a shootout with the Detroit Red Wings, you know, they have so much firepower that we can't play a game 9-7 or 9-8. We have to keep it very tight.
Yeah, you won the first time these two teams met, 6-4, but that was in November. And since, they have scored 10 goals in one game and 9 in the other.
Well, definitely. They have a lot of offensive firepower with Yzerman and Fedorov and, you know, Dino Cicerelli. They have a lot of players that can score. And I think our game plan tonight is a good, sound defensive game. And when we get a chance, capitalize on it.
Now, here is a team in Detroit that seems to play better on the road than it does at home. Yet, with all of these skaters, you know, what concerns you the most as you look across? There's Chiasson, who's going to be in the All-Star game with you. There's Yzerman and the like.
Well, definitely. You know, they, like I said, they have a lot of offensive firepower. And, you know, we have to contain those guys, and especially when we're on the ice against them. We have to know who we're out there against. If we're out there against Yzerman or your Fedorovs and stuff, you have to know you're out there against them and pay a little extra special attention.
You've been on the road a long, long time. It's going to be great to see the sign, "Welcome to Tampa Bay," isn't it? How do you stay focused on this evening's game? And from an emotional standpoint, is the team emotionally, mentally fatigued?
Well, you'd have to say we are a bit. We've been on the road for 2 weeks today, and it's been a long road trip, 9 games in a row. And, you know, everybody's looking forward to going home. But like I said, we have a job to do, and that's what they pay us. We're here tonight to play against Detroit Red Wings. We're going to go home tomorrow, and like I said, we have to focus on tonight's game.
Brian, I don't know what they pay you, but they certainly have gotten their money's worth this year. 32 goals thus far. How about a hat trick tonight?
I'd like one.
Brian Bradley, and for joining us, and perhaps, too, for heading to the All-Star game. He will enjoy dinner at the Longhorn Steak Restaurant and Saloon on Dale Mabry Highway, south of the stadium. And we will return to visit with Detroit's Mark Howe and more of our pregame show from the Joe in Detroit. We are in Detroit this evening for NHL action, a tradition-rich setting for National Hockey League play, and one of the great names in all of this sport, the name Howe. With us now, Mark Howe joining us. Mark, here is a team in Detroit that certainly could use a win here at home this evening. It's funny, this team seems to play better away from the Joe this year than it does here at home.
Yeah, I'm not sure about the past here. I know as being a member of other teams coming in here, it was always a tough battle. But we, I'd say over the last month or so, we've had a struggle at home. So, and it's hard. We, you know, the fans have been on us a little bit, but justifiably so. I mean, you go back to last game and we're playing adequate, but that just doesn't cut it.
Yeah, here is a team that won the Norris a year ago, is now in second place after a slow start, and many would say, looking on paper at the roster here, this club has all the pieces to win a cup, to be very competitive at the highest level.
Yeah, but it doesn't work that way. I mean, there's been a lot of teams in the past where they look great on paper and they haven't come through, and the team has to gel together. And we've had some excellent games, and then we've had some slow games. So, but the mark of a good team is a consistency, and we haven't had that yet. And but there's a lot of games left, and you know, we're working for that goal.
Let's talk about a couple of the individual pieces to this puzzle. And Steve Chisholm is having a career year, and here is a Stevie Eiserman set for his seventh All-Star game.
Well, Stevie's a great player, he's a multi-talented player, and Steve Chisholm, I talked to him because I've never known his career totals before, and he's approaching them, you know, pretty soon right now. But his both those guys work extremely hard, and they're an important part of this team. And if we can get everybody to work as hard as they do, then you know, I'm sure we'd do a lot better.
Let's talk about your career here. It began with an Olympic silver medal about 20 years ago. You played, of course, in the WHA, and with Philadelphia, went to a Stanley Cup final. Now back here with Detroit. What is left? The obvious is a Stanley Cup ring.
Yeah, and the biggest reason I came to Detroit, I became a free agent over the summertime, and there's two things to consider. One is a hockey team that I felt at least had a chance over the next few years of winning a Stanley Cup, mm-hmm. and also I have a wife and three children, and knowing the city of Detroit because I grew up here, and I know a lot of what goes on around here. There's a lot of opportunity for my kids, and I really thought they would enjoy here. So, you know, moving somewhere after being in Philadelphia for 10 years, it was a big step for me. And but by having my family happy, it makes things a lot easier for me to come in here and do my job.
And there's some beauty in the fact that you as a youngster, perhaps not in this arena, over at the Olympia, were running around when number 9 was skating over there, and here you come back and you can conclude your career in a Red Wing sweater.
Well, that's the way you hope it ends up that way. But as I said, I ended up signing a 2-year contract, and my original plans were to come play 2 years and maybe call it a day. But because I had about a year and a half, 2 years of problems with my back, but my back's been getting strong, and it all depends on one thing my dad always taught me is that as long as you're having fun, you just play as long as you can till, you know, till they lock the door on you. So, and again, I still love playing the game of hockey. I love the competition and the thrill of winning, and so I'm going to play as long as I can, and hopefully it's going to end here in Detroit.
You guys have had some fun with the Lightning. 19 goals in the last two games between these two teams. What will it take here this evening to win again?
Well, we were talking earlier. I see. I think it's about 15 against, though, too. So
yeah, the Lightning have scored a few.
Yeah. So I mean, they definitely have some talent. I mean, they've done a great job. I mean, there's a mixture of guys coming from all sorts mm-hmm. of places around the country, and they've come together and played like a team. But obviously, we're concentrating more on trying to keep our goals against down. And with most teams, if we can keep the goals against down, we feel we have a good chance of winning. So you know, that's been our primary goal lately.
Mark, thanks a lot. Good luck tonight.
All right, thank you.
Mark Howe of the Detroit Red Wings with us. And when we return, John Kelly and Danny Gare will join us in the Joe Louis Arena as the Lightning skate against the Detroit Red Wings. It's the 67th season of professional hockey in Detroit, and the first year Tampa Bay Lightning come a-calling to face one of the original six in the NHL. As we welcome you back inside the Joe Louis Arena, say hello to the voice of the Lightning, John Kelly, along with a former captain of the Detroit Red Wings in Danny Gere. Good to see you guys again, John. Good one here tonight.
Well, hopefully it'll be a good one. They've had their problems against the Red Wings, high-scoring games. If you like goals, we might have a few tonight for them.
Well, they've had a few in the past, John. The last time they were in here, they lost 10-5, so this hockey club has to cut down on goals against. Terry Crisp really wants to work better in his own zone.
A wonderful piece of news earlier this week, that and the fact that Brian Bradley was named to the Campbell Conference All-Stars.
Very well deserved. Brian Bradley is sixth overall in goals, and some players get added to the team simply because each team has to have a representative. That is not the case with Brian Bradley. He deserves to be in the All-Star game.
John, Denny, let's review the Campbell Conference All-Stars, perhaps have time, too, for the Whales. But you begin with the goaltenders here on the Whales as we start on that side of the league. And Patrick Roy, of course, from Montreal, heads that list.
He's the number one goaltender. Billington, who plays with New Jersey, was their choice. And Sidorkovich is the one coming from Ottawa because they needed someone from Ottawa.
And Eddie Belfour, of course, has been the top goaltender. His average is under 3 this year. Casey and Vernon, of course, the other goaltenders, Paul.
For defensemen on the Whale side, Danny.
Well, there's some good ones there. You look at Leach, Bork, Norris Trophy winner. Al Iafrady's a little bit of a surprise, having a strong year for the Washington Capitals.
He, of course, will skate Sunday night in Expo Hall. And on the Campbell side of things, oh, first the forwards here for the Whales.
Obviously, Lemieux will not be in the game unless he makes some kind of miraculous recovery. But a lot of Penguins, Mr. Gehr.
I'll look at the three. Top three are all Penguins. And Pat LaFontaine, who is right behind Lemieux, trying to catch him in the scoring race. Some pretty good names in the center ice positions there.
And for forwards, again, on the Whales.
Alexander Mogilny having an outstanding year, leading the Buffalo Sabres with 41 goals. You look at Oates, who's had a fine year. Joe Sakic and Pierre Turgeon also top forwards.
And for the Campbell on the defensive side.
Paul Coffey's had an excellent season. Chelios in Chicago. Jeff Brown is a first-time starter from the St. Louis Blues. And, of course, Chiasson here with the Red Wings.
At number 19, Stevie Yzerman, who you played with, Danny, is returning for the seventh time.
And, you know, he's never had a point in the All-Star games in all six that he's played. You see another 19 in Brian Bradley.
And the forwards, too, Jim.
Yari Kurri off to a great start. He slumped a bit recently. Other players, Roberts, Robitaille of the Kings, and Roenick just might be the best two-way forward in the Campbell Conference. He's a good one.
Quite a few members of this Lightning delegation, Danny, you included, skated at one time here, huh?
That's right. We played here for, I played 5 years. Ron Duguay, who's now doing the radio broadcast. Don Murdoch, who's a scout with the hockey clubs. So a lot of them around tonight and a lot of old faces here at Joe Louis Arena.
Dougie Crossman and Basil McRae included. The last time out on Monday night, the Lightning came up on the short end of a 4-2 score in Toronto.
And the key to that game was the fact that Toronto got all four goals in the power play. The Lightning, for one of the few times this year, Danny, were a bit undisciplined.
They were, especially behind their own zone, a lot of times taking penalties when you don't normally take them in your end, and that's what hurt them. The five-minute power play to Jablonski really hurt them. And Terry Crisp and Wayne Cashman mentioned that they have to be more disciplined in tonight's game.
Detroit played Monday night as well and fell here in the Joe to visiting St. Louis, Gabe in goal.
And he stopped all 31 shots, his first career shutout. And we're talking to the Detroit assistant coaches. In that game, the Red Wings outchanced St. Louis by a margin of 2-1. They hit two goal posts but could not score a goal.
And you look at St. Louis not putting a lot of shots on goal, played a perfect road game. They really lined up on the blue line, not giving an opportunity for the quick forwards to get in and set up.
Let's talk about who will play this evening, who's in and who's out for both teams. This was earlier in the day.
Shane Stephenson will be in the lineup. He will center a line tonight for Terry Crisp's club, and he's been a tough guy, and they might need the toughest tonight. The injuries, of course, DeMaio, Bureau, Hamerlick, and Ramage are scratched.
And those people like DeMaio and Bureau you like to have in a game like tonight because they love to play a physical game, John. Also, Rob Ramage, they feel they need a little time to give him a little bit of rest. He's one of the older players in the team.
The Red Wings like to play with a defensive style, keep the score down, but you wouldn't know it from looking at the totals in the last two games they played, certainly all three games between these two clubs.
Yeah, I don't know what it is. I guess it started down in Tampa when the Lightning won at 4-2, but the last two games, just out of control, 10-5, a goaltender's nightmare that night, Danny, here.
It was a goaltender's nightmare. And Terry Crisp said to me tonight, if we can keep them under five goals, we might have a chance to get a point or two, because they have scored some goals against them, as you see, 7-5 for them, but the Red Wings have really poured it on against them the last two games.
Detroit is the defending Norris Division champions, and it appears that your former club, Danny, has all the tools it needs to once again contend, if not this year, win the Cup.
They have the individuals, and that's maybe the key to this hockey club, is that they are very much individuals, and they do not play within a system. So that's one of the things. I know Brian Murray loves to play a system-type game, forechecking systems and breakout systems, but because of their individual skilled players, they have a tough time to have that cohesion.
And a busy week for the Lightning. How emotionally sharp can they be here this evening on the end of a 9-game road trip? And they got two more remaining after this week.
Yeah, that's a good question, gentlemen. Terry Crisp intimated the other day that this club is getting a bit weary. They've had a lot of flights, a lot of delays in airports and things like that. They might be a bit emotional down tonight, but you've got to dig down at a time like that and get the second win.
It's going to be good to see Tampa once again for both of you. I know. You two have a good one.
All right, you too, Paul.
John Kelly and Danny Gehr headed upstairs to call tonight's game, and we'll return to visit with Coach Terry Crisp in a moment here on Sunshine Network. The The Lightning are in Detroit to take on the Red Wings as we welcome you inside the Joe Louis Arena and say hello to Tampa Bay coach Terry Crisp. I wonder if room tips and transfers were included in this two-week road show, huh?
If so, you could have paid the players by that and they'd have been happy. They'd have made a fortune on it. That was part of it. I noticed you were digging deep in your pocket the last 2 days.
Thank you. Just to pay cab fare, it's been a long, long time since you've seen Tampa Bay. What's the team's emotional state as you get ready for this evening's game?
Well, we're not very happy with the win and loss record. That's the first off. And the guys would like to end it on a positive note. We're heading home. We want to win. And tonight, it's not just one of those ones where, let's get in, play the game, and get out of here. We warned ourselves about that. Detroit got beat 1-0 last game in here. They want some vengeance against somebody. We're the next team in. We better be prepared tonight to go gung-ho.
Why does Detroit seem to struggle at home but play well above 500 away from the Joe?
Probably the biggest thing is when you have a good team, and Detroit, they are a very, very good team, you sometimes have a tendency to take home for granted. That, oh, well, we're home, we can relax a little. Uh-huh. But when they go on the road, they know they're a good team. They know that people want to see them on the road. The other fans want to see what Detroit's made of. They put a little extra into it. And that's the bane of all coaches, trying to get guys to say, listen, boys, just because you're at home doesn't mean the team coming in is going to take it easy on you.
Earlier this evening, we visited with Brian Bradley. Congratulations to him, obviously. He's headed to the All-Star game.
That's well-deserved recognition for Brian Bradley. I mean, he's earned that right. He's paid his time, earned his spurs, and the guys were happy. We announced it the other day at practice, and believe me, Brad was taking a lot of ribbing over this one.
You added Basil McRae to his line. It seems to have given him a bit of room as he works also with John Tucker.
Well, we were talking earlier about it, that the liberties that were being taken with Brian Bradley had to stop. They had to cease. No more. The funny thing is, when Basil McRae came back, they did cease.
Yeah.
They start to stop. And it gives them room to operate. Plus, Baz is the type of player that when he goes to the front of the net, he's there. He's got decent hands around the net for Brad and Tucker to operate. So it opens up a whole lot for Brian Bradley and Tucker.
Detroit has scored a lot of goals against you in the last two meetings, but you've gotten a few too. What are the keys to success here tonight?
Again, the biggest key is we do not want to get into a run-and-gun battle with Detroit. We have to try and keep the tempo to our pace, the goals against down, so they don't get the bit in their teeth and get running with it, because once they do, they got the type of team that they just love to fill your net. We watched a tape of St. Louis in here the other night. St. Louis came in and beat them 1-0, and St. Louis tried to keep the flow at a low tempo.
Busy week for you. After this, you have both St. Louis and then the Washington Capitals, who are playing very, very well. I just thought I'd let you know how you're spending your weekend.
I just thought you were going to throw it in again. Every second night, we're on the move again. There's no rest for the wicket, and we better be ready.
Terry Crisp, good luck against the Red Wings tonight.
Hey, can always use lots of that. Thanks.
And our game is next from the Joe here with John Kelly and Danny Gare on Sunshine Network. Known as Tampa Bay's first NHL All-Star, center Brian Bradley returned to Toronto two nights ago and scored his 32nd goal of the season on the very day he was named to the All-Star Classic. Tonight, Bradley and the Lightning skate against Detroit and face a superstar in red, Stevie Yzerman, set to appear in his seventh All-Star game. Live from Detroit, a game sparkling with stars on Sunshine Network. Sunshine Network welcomes you to snowy Detroit and to the National Hockey League. From the Joe, here in Motown, the Tampa Bay Lightning look to upend the powerful Red Wings in this matchup of two Norris Division rivals. As we say hello, good evening, and welcome inside the Joe Louis Sports Arena, and welcome to the NHL on Sunshine Network. I'm Paul Kennedy, your host this evening, as the Lightning play the ninth and final game of a very long road trip. Monday evening found Tampa Bay in Toronto and on the short end of a 4-2 score in a game in which Tampa Bay led at one point 2-1. That was the first of four games the Lightning will play this week. We are in Detroit tonight, and then on Saturday host the St. Louis Blues at home at Expo Hall, and Sunday Ally Frady and the Washington Capitals will be in Tampa as well. Monday evening, too, found the Detroit Red Wings on the ice. They were here in the Joe, but once again lost at home, 1-0. And as you see, this team peculiarly plays better away from the Joe than here inside. 13-11-1 at home, 10-8-2 away from Detroit. Go figure. Perhaps an opportunity for Tampa Bay to upset the defending Norris Division champions here this evening. In a moment, we will be joined by the voice of the Lightning, John Kelly, along with a former Red Wing captain in Danny Gare for tonight's play-by-play call. It's Tampa Bay and Detroit live tonight on Sunshine Network. Of professional hockey in Detroit, and tonight the first-year Lightning skating against one of the NHL's original six. And here with our play-by-play call, once again, John Kelly and Danny Gare. Good evening, gentlemen.
All right, Paul, and good evening to everybody down in Florida on the Lightning TV network here on Sunshine Network as the Lightning take on the Red Wings here tonight. And, you know, we talked about the goalie situation at the outset of this road trip, and the Lightning still have three goaltenders, something that a lot of people say could end in the near future.
Well, there has been talk, John, that maybe Wendell Young will go down to Atlanta for conditioning purposes for a couple weeks. Wendell has not played much hockey in the last month, and I know that it's very important that this hockey club gets Wendell into some games and gets some playing time.
Well, the man in nets tonight is J.C. Bergeron. He has been quite a story for Tampa Bay. He came up from the minors where he lost only three games, and he has a very nice goals against average here in the NHL.
And he has won three of the five games he's played on the road, John, the five wins that he's had. And J.C. Bergeron played his first game ever in this building with the Montreal Canadiens, his first National Hockey game, and he lost that game 5-2, but J.C. wants to play well tonight for this hockey club.
Well, the man who will be in the All-Star game February 6th is Brian Bradley. We talked about him a bit earlier, and he continues to shine. Had a big goal the other night in Toronto against his former club.
Well, as you mentioned earlier, Brian Bradley deserves to be on the NHL All-Star team. Unfortunately, his wife, Carrie, who's expecting February 14th, Valentine's Day, with their first child, will not be there. So that's a little bit of a disappointment. But Brian looking very much forward to playing in Montreal with the rest of the All-Stars.
When you think of the Red Wings, you have to think of Steve Yzerman. He is, without a doubt, one of the greatest players in the National Hockey League, a former teammate of yours. You know him well.
Stevie's a great player, a great leader. He can skate and turn games around. There you see his points. He's third on the Wings all-time scoring list behind Delvecchio and Gordie Howe, and he ranks amongst the best that have ever played in a Detroit Red Wing uniform.
And the Red Wings are very deep at center. That man, Yzerman. They also have Jimmy Carson. And the Soviet import, Sergei Fedorov, he might have as much talent as Yzerman.
He has, but a knock against Sergei Fedorov is the fact that he may not work as hard as a Steve Yzerman. He has had a problem with the shoulder injury. He's wearing a brace on it right now on his right shoulder, John. And when he's not playing, the Red Wings have only won one of the five games that he was out.
So it's Fedorov and Yzerman here at home against the Tampa Bay Lightning as they wrap up this long nine-game road trip. First period coming up after these messages.
The NHL on Sunshine Network featuring tonight's game between the Tampa Bay Lightning and the homestanding Detroit Red Wings is brought to you by GTE, a proud supporter of professional sports in the Tampa Bay area. By Gatorade, it's all you're thirsting for. By Great Western Bank's family of companies, $38 billion strong. By Budweiser, the only beer with a taste as genuine as the people who drink it, nothing beats a Bud. And by the Discover Card, it pays to discover the card that pays you back.
You are looking live at Joe Louis Arena in Detroit, Michigan, the home of the Red Wings, and tonight it's the Tampa Bay Lightning against their Norris Division rivals, the Red Wings. With Paul Kennedy and Danny Gare, I'm John Kelly back. It's great to have you with us. Should be a fun night as the Lightning wrap up this nine-game road trip looking for their second win during this very prolonged journey. Well, both clubs are lined up for the national anthem. J.C. Bergeron, the goaltender for the Lightning. Tim Cheveldae, the goaltender for the Red Wings. Now Stephanie Fried with the anthem.
The line was so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight o'er the ramparts we watched were so
Miss Stephanie Freed with the national anthem here in Detroit, and J.C. Bergeron gets the call for Tampa Bay.
And John, he felt he could have had a better game in his last game out in Minneapolis. He wants to come back with a strong game here tonight. He's got some great goals against statistics, and Bergeron today said he feels good for tonight's game.
And at the other end is 24-year-old Tim Chevalier, native of Melville, Saskatchewan, the Red Wings' number one man.
He is their number one man, 3.45 goals against. You look at his wins, 14 wins, and Chevalier played the most games ever by a Red Wing goaltender last year as he tied Kirk McLean with 72 games.
And he has started the last three, although he has picked up only one victory in his last four outings. The referee, Mike Magoo, the linesman, Jay Scherz, and Mark Wheeler. And we are underway with the first period here in Motown. Glad to have you with us. As McCray begins and dumps it in, Bradley and Tucker up there as well. Red Wings back, Chiasson gets it ahead, and Chambers can't hold it in. And this is McCray, number 17, back for the Lightning. He just bangs it off the boards. Konstantinov there for the Red Wings. Now Chambers, his pass too far for McCray. And going back for the Red Wings, Steve Chiasson, their all-star defenseman. And an early icing call here against Tampa Bay.
There's a take a look at the referee that also did the last game in Toronto, Magoo. And he made a lot of interesting calls in that game, John. One of 5-minute majors. You look at Terry Criss. Talk to Terry today. One of the things he said today, this hockey game cannot have a run-and-shoot type game. They've got to have a non-flow type game and slow them down. And there's the forwards that are going to have to help out in that area. McCray stays with Bradley and Tucker. Kontos, Creighton, and Anderson. The checking line of Casper, Zamner, and Malte. Stevenson in the lineup tonight along with Danton Cole with Mike Hartman, the native of Detroit.
And not dressed tonight, Ramage, Biro, DeMaio, and Hammerlick. Biro and DeMaio are injured. Red Wings get the draw. Chiasson shot is wide. Now they try and keep it in. Chiasson does, but Bergeron knocks it away. Up for Cole, who went to school here in Michigan at Michigan State. Danton Cole with Zamener and Casper. Now Konstantinov there. Cole blocked the pass. Tries to walk in front, but it's tipped away. And now Vladimir Konstantinov, the Soviet player. For Gallant. Now ahead for Cicerelli. Can't penetrate the blue line. And Dino Cicerelli goes back in his own end. Now for Chiasson. Steve Chiasson centers it. And Fedorov can't get to it. And Mark Bergevin plays it back to center ice. A minute 15 gone, first period, no score. Now the rookie Dallas Drake in there for the Red Wings. Looks to center, he does! Fedorov is there, and a save by Bergeron. And now play called as Bergeron was knocked down, and the goal may have come loose as the Red Wings just put that puck in front and went to the net.
And that's what most coaches want from their forwards, especially a player of Dallas Drake's skills. He makes a good move on Chambers, throws the puck ahead to Fedorov, and then watch the play here, bouncing around in front of Jablonski, and then gets bumped into the net by Izabard. There's the shot there, not a good shot, but Jablonski did cover up. See him getting bumped there by Paul Izabard into the goalpost as you take a look at Sergei Fedorov, along with Dave Lewis, who is coaching tonight for Brian Murray. Murray also the GM and coach here out in La Quinta with all the general managers. Dave Lewis coached his first game and a 1-0 loss against St. Louis on Monday.
And actually, a couple of years ago, he was an interim coach when Jacques Demers got sick here in Detroit, and he tied that game. So he's winless in two games. Now Creighton walks in, a shot, but Chevalier saved. Hartman a drive, and that was wide as well. And the puck picked up by Big Bob Probert. His pass broken up by Hartman. He feeds Chris Kontos. Kontos, Creighton, and Hartman. And the Lightning flip it in. No icing here as Markow goes back. Pass picked off by Kontos. He's tripped up by Probert. Creighton in there for Tampa Bay, and a hand pass from one Lightning player to the other, and that draws a whistle.
There's big Adam Creighton, who's really struggled of late putting the puck in the net. Take a look at the Detroit lines. Fedorov, Izabart, and Drake, their top line, along with Berg Cummins, who was brought up from Adirondack, a big tough guy, and Keith Primo, the 6'4" left winger. Iserman, Cicerelli, and Gallant reunited. Carson Shepherd and Big Bob, the tough guy, Probert.
No score. 2:10 gone in the first period. Now Lidstrom for Detroit sends it in. Going back, Taglianetti. Can't clear it. Probert grabs it. He can't walk in front. And Sean Chambers, who grew up here in Detroit. Chambers now ahead. Molte gets it in there, but Lidstrom, the second-year player from Sweden, back in his own end. Nicholas Lidstrom. He struggled a bit this year, works it in. And Sean Chambers tries to clear it out, kept in. Probert there. Carson in front, a shot. That hit a leg and went wide. Now behind the goal, Probert. Tied up by Anderson. Probert big and strong, but he's knocked down by Mikhail Anderson. And the Lightning taking no chances, ice it here. And we get a whistle and a face-off back in the Lightning end.
Talking to Wayne Cashman and Terry Crisp, they're not afraid of icing the puck here, much like St. Louis did the other night in playing a perfect road game. You see the record here, the series record against these two hockey clubs. A lot of goals, over 40 goals scored in the last three games. And you know that they do not want to get in that type of a game again tonight. They want to keep the defensemen up on the blue line so that the good players like Fedorov and Yzerman do not have time to wheel and deal inside the blue line. And they really want a non-flow game, John.
In three games, the Lightning, 18 goals. That's an average of 6 a night. That's great. But they've given up an average of 7.6 a game. That's not so great. And now an offside. But it's very easy to get caught up into a free-flowing game here. The Red Wings have as much firepower as anyone in the league.
Well, I mentioned about the fact that the skills that they have, skilled players on this hockey team, you look at their lineup, they have a possibility of 8 players getting 20 goals or more, and that's one of them right there, Paul Yzerbart, number 21.
No score. 16:45 left here in the first. Fedorov in front. Big save by Bergeron on Drake the rookie. And back is Tucker. He gets it in. Konstantinov there, gave it away. Now McCrae gets the puck for John Tucker. Looks to center it. Tucker tied up back there. Red Wings try and work it out. Now Brian Bradley after it. Gets it back for Beers. Beers to McCrae, right in, a shot. He scores! Basil McCrae! It may have been tipped in by Tucker, but the Lightning have taken a 1-0 lead.
Terry Crisp and Wayne Cashman told his forwards tonight to go in and try to forecheck this defense. It's having some problems of late. Basil McCrae will take the shot as you see them cough up the puck along the boards. Watch Bradley. He'll move it across, and then it'll go to Beers, who slides it to McCrae. He just lets go a quick wrist shot. It may have been tipped by John Tucker. Maybe not, but this one goes by Timmy Chevalier. 1-0, the Lightning lead. I don't know whether this touched Tucker's stick, but you can see the good quick wrist shot there by McCrae. May have dropped a little on the tip by Tucker, but a big goal by the Lightning here early in this first period.
Big goal indeed at 3:47 as they get the first one and take a 1-0 lead. Either Tucker or McCrae with the goal. And it is Tucker who tips it in, his 7th of the year. McCrae and Beers will get the assist. So it's 1-0. Red Wings try and keep it in, but it comes to center. Mark Howe now. So Tucker gets the goal. His 7th of the year. And it's good to see him score a goal. Now a pass by Riki for Kasper. Rob Zamener now at center to Crossman. The ex-Red Wing gets it in, but it's broken up by Howe. Crossman has it again. Plays it in off the boards. And Chevalier sets it up for Howe. And the fans on Chevalier a bit. I don't know why he only allowed one goal last game, and I guess they felt he could have stopped Tucker's shot. But it was tipped on the way through. Howe, a pass in for Yzerman, always dangerous. In front, and tipped in front by Gallant, but wide, and now penalty away from the play. An interference call, I believe, against the Lightning. We'll return for more after this from GTE.
Steve Yzerman looking for Dino Cicerelli, but Peter Taglianetti has him tied up right to the left of the post as you see him knock him down, interfering with him. Taglianetti goes off for an interference call. Red Wings on the power play.
Lightning lead it 1-0. Fedorov feeds it in front. Carson is there, but John Tucker got back and checked him. A great play. And Steve Kasper will work it back to center ice. And he fires it down the ice. So the Red Wings on the power play this year, they're fourth overall at 23.3%. Tucker broke it up. He's got a breakaway. No, alone. Shorthanded. Tucker. A shot. And a save by Chevalier as Tucker got to a very bad angle and never got a great chance.
John Tucker making a fine defensive play earlier as Terry Crispus' coach looks on, hoping that it would have been a shorthanded effort. But watch the turnover here. Tucker coming in all alone by himself as he'll come in. Watch him lose the puck here as he looks to make the move or the deke. It just falls off the pole of his stick and he tries to put the backhand towards Chevalier. But John Tucker, picking up his seventh goal, is having a good start here in this hockey game.
As that puck just rolled off your stick, that's what happens when you go to the backhand. It's a bit tougher to control when you're on your backhand.
And especially when Tucker uses a pretty good hook on his stick also, John.
There's the power play numbers. Pretty good for Detroit, and they've done great against the Lightning in three games. 7 of 18 on the power play. Lightning up 1-0. Red Wings try and set it up. Covert in there, checked by Chambers. And Danton Cole trying to fire it out. Kept in by Chiasson. Chambers there again, so is Cole. And Danton will ice it with under a minute left in the Red Wings power play. Chiasson ahead again. The Lightning on the penalty killing this year. Second worst. And you can see that penalty killing can win you or lose you a lot of games. They allowed 4 goals in 9 opportunities against Toronto. Now the Red Wings play it in. Beers will get it again. He has lots of time, and here come the Lightning. Beers to Tucker, 2-on-2. Long shot, pad saved by Chevalier, 25 seconds left. And Taglianetti's minor. Probert now in there. Probert, near side for Sheppard. In front, but back there with Zaminer. And the Lightning doing a good job as they kill it off.
And the Bluebirds come out here in this first period. This crowd is very fickle, I guess. The last game in which they lost 1-0 to the St. Louis Blues, they booed the team most of the first period, John.
Well, they've lost 3 of the last 5 home games here at Joe Louis Arena as we get a face-off. And the penalty has expired. Well, don't miss the Times night on January 16th when the Lightning come home to take on St. Louis, and be there early to receive your St. Petersburg Times rowdy towel. And that should be a rowdy night as they come back from 9 games on the road.
That's right. And as you take a look at Chiasson here coming up, he's the one of the all-star representatives for the Detroit Red Wings. Chiasson having one of the better years of his career with 9 goals and 27 assists for 36 points.
And that's 10th best among all defensemen. It's 1-0 for the Lightning. 13 minutes left in the first. Teams at full strength. Now the Red Wings work it right back in. Konstantinov, a wrist shot, and that was just wide. And the puck cleared to center ice. Now Konstantinov fires it back in. Icing coming up here. And as Rieke gets it, and then he was manhandled a bit by the rookie Jim Cummins. And we get a stoppage in play. We'll have more hockey after this from Budweiser. Nothing beats a Bud. It's 1-0 for the Lightning. Tucker's goal from McCray and Beers at 3:47. As the Lightning have outshot the Red Wings 4-2, and they've played quite well.
And they killed off a big penalty on almost scored on the shorthanded effort as Tucker had a giveaway handed right to him in the neutral zone, but lost the puck on the deep.
Red Wings off the draw. Gets the puck for Drake, the rookie, but Bradley kept it in. Bradley in traffic. McCray there to help out. Centers it. And Chevalier kicked it away. And Izobart now at center ice. Lost it. And Beers at his own line. He set out the last game. Now Beers, good pass to Bradley. Here he comes. A shot and a save. Now they center it. Here's Beers again. Fires it right on. A save by Chevalier. And the rebound cleared away. Fedorov at center to Drake. Tries to work it in. Broken up the Red Wings. Very quick with the transition game, as you can see. Izobart now feeds Markow, but Tucker there to break it up. Gets it out, brought back in by Izobart. Paul Izobart in front, and it's tipped just wide in behind the goal by Drake. Now Fedorov in front. Oh, he's above! And he put it wide from the slot, and McRae feeds Tucker. One man back. John Tucker works in on Chiasson. Can't get around him. Now gets some help. That pass knocked away, though, and Drake. Pass for Iserman. Sends it into Chiasson. Hook down, no call. 11:15 to go first period, and the Lightning lead it 1-0. This is Stevenson with some good speed. Gene Stevenson works in. Wrist shot and a glove save by Chevalier as Stevenson showed some good speed at center ice.
Well, Shane Stevenson did not play in Toronto, but he's matched up here with Maltes and Anderson and showed good speed to the neutral zone, taking the quick wrist shot as you take a look at Pat Jablonski. And there's Stevenson, number 9. He changed his number from 40 to 9. He felt he is more of a forwards number. He's only got one assistant, but he works very well as you see him skating here through the neutral zone. Watch him put a little fake and then shoot the puck. And as a youngster, you want to shoot the puck and try to use that defenseman as a screen, and that's exactly what Stevenson tried to do on that play.
The Lightning began this 9-game road trip December 21st. Shane Stevenson began a road trip with Atlanta on the 19th of December. Here's a Chambers drive, and that goes wide. So Stevenson has been away from his hometown, his home, longer than the Lightning. And he told me he only brought two suits. I would like to be on the road for a month and have two suits.
How much underwear did he bring?
I didn't ask him that. In comes Malte, wrist shot, oh, and Chevalier, a pad save. And it went just wide, now it's stolen in there. Malte centers it, broken up by the Red Wings. Here comes Iserman, their captain. You gotta watch him. Oh, good play by Taglinetti to knock him down. That's the way to stop Iserman. And Stevenson now to Malte. 3-on-3 here. Steve Malte trying to barge in there. Broken up by the Red Wings. Iserman gets it out. Played back in by Kasper. Now Iserman again. It's 1-0 for the Lightning. Now Gallant in there for the Red Wings. To Cicerelli. Back for Lidstrom. Wrist shot right on. A save by Bergeron with Gallant all over him. And Cole back to center ice. For Steve Kasper. Here's Kasper in there. Looks to center, and he does. But no one is there. And the Wings whack it off the boards out of trouble. Now Crossman gets it. Pass for Cole. He fires it back in. Then he was dumped down by Probert. And Chevalier fires it off the boards to center. Now Crossman to Kasper. The Lightning have played well here. Nothing fancy. Get the puck out and get it down the ice and forecheck. That's the game plan tonight. Crossman number 3. Now for Rieke. He flips it high to center. Creighton can't get it. Now it's grabbed by Doug Crossman. Crossman works in, has some room. Quick shot and a pad save. They center one. Kontos missed it. And back come the Red Wings, but Crossman knocked it off Shepherd's stick with a good play. Now Kontos back at his own line. Pass ahead by Beers into Kontos. Right in a shot. Pad save by Chevalier. And Kontos got a loose puck. And Probert, the Red Wing bad guy to center ice. Probert to Shepherd. Now for Carson. Back in front. Broken up though, and Mike Hartman, the Detroit native, to center ice. It's 1-0 for the Lightning on John Tucker's goal. 8:35 to go first period. Now McCrimmon for the Red Wings. For Mark Howe, number 4. He just gets it in deep. Casey Bergeron left it there. Big hit in there by Probert. Tucker on the board. So is Beers. Now Bergeron plays one to the far side. Hartman checked by Sean Burr, but it comes free and Mark Bergevin gets it out to Bradley. Now for Tucker. He goes after it. And it's chucked away by Howe. Primo now for the Red Wings. But getting back with Taglinetti to break it up. Good play. And now Konstantinov for Detroit. And that pass across two lines. And we get a face-off. So a good start for the Lightning. It's Tampa Bay 1 and Detroit no score.
This is what the Lightning defensemen have to do against the skilled players, Iserman. They have to take the body on them, not let them get time to set up. As you'll see Taglinetti knock him down. And then the shot here by Lidstrom. But watch the quick movement in the zone. A good breakout. Crossman will throw the puck up quickly to Cole, and then he'll move it out the zone. That's what they have to continue to do in order for them not to set up.
Now the Red Wings in there. Fedorov on his backhand, back on the point. Bradley broken up, and here he comes. Bradley in there. Konstantinov back. Bradley, McRae, and Tucker up front. Now Tucker steals it back there. McRae can't center it. And the Red Wings take over. Fedorov with Drake and Izobard. Nice move at center now by Konstantinov. And Bergeron will flip it up the boards. Chase on left point, kept it in, but now Sean Chambers there for the Lightning. He works ahead, and he'll just dump it in. 7:05 left in the first period. And the Lightning lead it 1-0. Now Chase on ahead at center. Heiserman lost it. Mikael Anderson lost an edge. Now the puck handed back to Anderson. Mikael Anderson with Molte and Stevenson. Anderson looks to center it. In for Molte. Gets it in front. Poked away though. And Cicerelli at center ice. Look out here. Heiserman in with Gallant. Heiserman right in. And it was knocked away on a good defensive play by Doug Crosman. Now Gallant in there for the Red Wings. In behind the goal. Wraparound, they score! Cicerelli! And it's 1-1.
Dino Cicerelli picks up his 17th goal of the season, as you see some good work down low by Gerard Gallant. He'll just give it to Cicerelli. No one picks him up, and he does the wraparound and sticks it in between the legs of J.C. Bergeron. Watch Crossman go for one, and you'll see number 9 Stevenson go the wrong way behind the net to pick up Cicerelli. And that's Cicerelli's 17th goal of the year. Cicerelli, the reason he was traded to this hockey club was to help the offense, and he's doing that again this year.
So Cicerelli ties the game from Gallant and Iserman at 13:30. That was just the Red Wings' 4th shot. The Lightning have had 10. Now the puck behind the Red Wing goal picked up by Lidstrom. He fires it ahead. Gallant with Iserman again. Pass across, Cicerelli in front. And tip wide by Iserman. He was taken down. And a penalty called, holding against Tampa Bay.
And I believe this one will be going to Bobby Beers as he tied up Iserman, who was trying to drive to the net. And now the Lightning will go on their second penalty killing situation. They killed off the first one successful. 1-1 score here. Here you take a look at Cicerelli's trying to throw that puck to Iserman. He does get a stick on it, but there's Beers tying him up. You've got to always be aware of Iserman anytime he's on the ice. Beers tied him up a little bit too much, John, and he's off for holding.
That goal by Cicerelli, his first goal since December 26th. So he's been in a bit of a goal-scoring drought, but he gets number 17 from Gallant and Iserman at 13:30, and now Tampa Bay shorthanded. And the puck flipped ahead. Tonight, the Red Wings 0-1, but again on the year, they're 4th overall. And 7 power play goals against the Lightning in 19 opportunities. Now the Red Wings are seen ahead for Carson. Pass in on the wing, broken up by Kasper. And Sean Chambers plays it ahead. Chase on again. Here comes Steve Chase on for Shepherd. Into the corner for Chase on this Detroit power play. Now on the far side, they work it back on the point. Racine shot, and that hit Kasper, and it bounces back to center. Shepherd now for Jimmy Carson. 1:15 to go in the power play. In for Shepherd. Loose puck, Fedorov gets it. A shot, he scores! Sergei Fedorov, a power play goal!
That's number 20 for Sergei Fedorov as he picks the puck up right in the slot area. It bounces off the chest of one of his forwards, and watch the shot here. He pulls in and then throws it between the legs of number 32, Paglianetti, and also the goaltender, J.C. Bergeron. Watch the play here. It bounces up off the chest, goes right to Fedorov, a little inside-outside move, and then uses Paglianetti as the screen. Bergeron had no chance on it. 2-1 Detroit.
So Fedorov, who had 32 goals last year, hits the 20-goal mark in his third year from the Soviet Union. Shepard gets the assist along with Carson, and it's 2-1 for the Red Wings. And a power play goal puts the Wings ahead. Kontos knocks it down. Pass in for Big Adam Creighton, and he can't get a shot away. As Creighton had a pretty good chance. And Mark Howe works it back to center ice. Mark Bergevin there. But McCrimmon fires it right back in. And now Beers for the Lightning. Puts it ahead for Kontos. He was bumped down. Now Hartman carries on. And Mike Hartman plays it in behind the Red Wing goal. 4:25 left in the first. It's 2-1 Detroit. Now Primo, their former first-round pick, fires it down the ice. McCray there. Bumped by Primo. Now Burr for the Red Wings plays it behind the goal, but Mark Bergevin picks it up. Up to Big Basil McCray. McCray now for Bradley. Never saw the pass. Red Wings play it back in. Cicerelli. Oh, he runs Bergevin down. Big hit there. Yzerman gets the puck. Back to Chiasson. A shot. Never got through. Yzerman in the corner. Taken out. And now we get penalties here. Cicerelli and McCray were involved in front. Cicerelli lost his helmet. And he'll go off. It's 2-1 Detroit late here in the first period.
A couple of combatants in the corner. Mark Bergevin, I should say, and Dino Cicerelli. You'll see Bergevin pull him down there, and Cicerelli gets a little upset with him, gives him a shot back, and then they went in front of the net with some high sticking, and they're both off for that on 2-minute minors. You see the pushing and shoving going on in front, and there's the high stick there. And Bergevin gets called, as well as Dino. So they'll play four apiece, John.
High sticking minors here at 16:20. So the Red Wings have taken a 2-1 lead. Cicerelli tied the game at 13:30. Then the power play goal, Fedorov at 14:54 from Shepard and Carson. Tucker has scored for Tampa Bay. As the puck is shot around the boards, Red Wings keep it in, but now Sean Chambers takes over. Each team a man short here with Cicerelli and Bergevin off. Lots of room on the ice. Pass for Taglinetti at center ice to John Tucker. He pokes it in. Then Chevalier sets it up for Konstantinov. He gets it ahead. Now it's center ice. Long pass by Shepard into Chiasson. A shot! Pad saved by Bergeron, and the rebound stopped as Yzerman let it go. And now Bradley back to center ice. Ryan Bradley with 32 goals this year. 24 assists. And 56 points. What a year for the All-Star. Bradley gets it again. Needs some help in there. Knocked down. And now Konstantinov with a minute left in the coincidental minors. 2.5 minutes left in the first. Red Wings up 2-1. Here's Izabart. Puts it in front, but Doug Crossman broke it up. And Crossman plays it off the boards down the ice. And Racine going back for Detroit. We're seeing a good puck-handling defenseman, former first-round pick of the Red Wings. But now Crossman there for Stevenson. Can't send Anderson in, and Fedorov for the Red Wings. Fedorov works in around Crossman in front, and Izabart put it just wide. Now Lidstrom pinches in. Taken to the boards by Mikael Anderson. And Rieke gets the loose puck with under 2 minutes left here in the first period. And Rieke carries ahead. Now for Stevenson. Shane Stevenson trying to barge through the defense, can't. And Carson takes over for Detroit. Now for Lidstrom, the penalized players, Cicerelli and Bergevin back on, so the club's at full strength. Chambers behind his goal. Lidstrom pinches in. In deep, now it comes in front, but Chambers knocked it away. And Casper there for the Lightning. Around the boards, And Chambers gets it for Cole at center ice. Back to Chambers. In with Cole. Oh, and Cole is just offside on left wing. And we get a whistle. Pretty good rush there, but it was just offside. Let's go downstairs to Paul Kennedy.
Thank you very much, John and Danny. And coming up between periods, we'll visit with still another All-Star who's here this evening, the defenseman Steve Chasen. And we'll also update you on other scores this evening. And Skip Thayer, the head trainer for the Lightning, will discuss Mario Lemieux's condition. He, of course, was with Mario the last four seasons in Pittsburgh. All that ahead between periods. John?
All right, Paul, we look forward to that. 1:10 to go here in the first. 2-1 Detroit leading. Yzerman ahead. Gets it in. Gerard Gallant is there. But Beaters knocked it away. Now Cicerelli for Yzerman. In front to Howe. A shot, and he put it just high over the net. Then Creighton back there for the Lightning. He comes to center ice with Kontos. Then Hartman. Pass into Hartman. Howe knocked the puck off his stick. And the puck taken by Gallant for Brad McCrimmon. Long backhander turned away by Bergeron. And the puck flipped ahead by Beers. Here's Creighton again. He'll just dump it in. 25 seconds left in the first. The Red Wings lead by one. Chase on again. Long dump in. Cicerelli pokes it in deep. Chambers knocks it around the boards for Cole. He tries to clear. Doesn't. Chase on a shot. That's blocked. Chase on again. Another shot. Look out. And that's knocked away by Taglinetti, and that'll do it. 3 seconds left. Bob Zaminer will kill the clock here. One last shot. And that's stopped, and the period comes to an end. The Lightning struck first on a Tucker goal, but Cicerelli and Fedorov reply for Detroit. And after one here at Joe Louis Arena, the score, the Red Wings 2 and the Lightning 1. Stay tuned for our first intermission activities. They are next here on Sunshine Network. 2-1 after one period of play, Joe Louis Arena located in downtown Detroit on the banks of the Detroit River. Tucker scored to make it 1-0 at 3:47. McCray and Beers the assist. Cicerelli at 13:30, Gallant and Yzerman the assist, and the power play goal by Fedorov, his 20th, from Shepherd and Carson. And the first period stats brought to you by the Discover card. It pays to discover the card that pays you back.
Well, John, the big problem here was that the Lightning did not get any power plays. The Red Wings had two and capitalized on the one. That's the difference in the score. And look at the turnovers. Turnovers 4-2. Have been a big difference, and the Lightning have not capitalized on those turnovers.
And the second period just underway here in Detroit. Teams at full strength. As Chase on back in his own zone. For Konstantinov. Now Fedorov. A very exciting player from the Commonwealth of Independent States. Now Fedorov in there. Drop pass, but Taglinetti broke it up. He feeds McCray with Chambers and Tucker. And Chambers is going off, and he just flips it in. Chase on a pass. That's center for Isobart, now to Fedorov. That high wrist shot is off the glass. And Cole back for Tampa Bay. He missed 10 games with that knee injury and is wearing a brace on that left knee. Bradley in there to help out. And Bradley and Cole work at the center ice. Cole now to Bradley, in with McCray. Bradley right in. Great chance here, and a drop pass to Cole was intercepted. And the puck to center ice. Now Beers for McCray. He flips it in. Red Wings up 2-1. Back in their own zone, Shepherd left it. Konstantinov for Carson. He gets it out. Now Konstantinov for Probert. He can't walk around Beers. And the puck played away to center ice. Chason, who sees a lot of ice time, gets it in, but Beers again. Now for Bergevin, wasn't ready for it. Probert is in there. Probert muscles in front, but it's poked off his stick by Bergevin. And now Kasper with Cole to center ice. Kasper in there can't get a shot. And going back is McCrimmon for Detroit number two. To Ray Shepherd, the ex-Sabre and Ranger. Pass into Probert. One man back, and Crossman blocked that. Now Probert has it again. But Crossman stole the puck. And the Lightning try and get something going here. To Zaminer. Tipped it ahead. Probert back in his own zone now for McCrimmon. Center ice pass. And it's just poked in there by Shepard as the Red Wings make a change on the move. Crosspin now for Molte. Gets by a one man, but Yzerman got back. Held in though. Here's Stevenson right in a drive and a pass save. Great play now. Shot by Crosspin. Never got through. Oh, what a play there by Stevenson. Now Lidstrom behind his goal for Detroit. Looks to clear it, held in by Creighton. Can't center it though. And the Red Wings, Burr gets it out to Yzerman. Back to Sean Burr. He races to the corner. Now Cicerelli, a bad angle shot, and that was well wide. Lidstrom kept it in. Now behind the goal, Yzerman missed it. And Rinke plays it around the boards. Kept in by Racine. Long shot, and that was just wide. Now Lidstrom, a slapper. That was blocked. Molte can't clear it. Now Gerard Gallant there for the Red Wings. Gallant for Racine. Another shot, and Yzerman tipped it just wide of the far post. Now back to Lidstrom again. Another wrist shot, and that's off the glass and cleared very smartly by Chambers. And icing coming up here against the Lightning. 3.5 minutes into the second, the Red Wings with a 2-1 lead over Tampa Bay. We'll be right back. Early in the second period, you are watching Lightning Hockey on Sunshine Network. This game brought to you in part by Gillette and the revolutionary Gillette Sensor Shaving System. Gillette, the best a man can get. Face off to the left of Bergeron. And Kontos fires it down the ice. No icing here. Konstantinov left it, and it's picked up by the rookie Cummins. Jim Cummins called up a couple of weeks ago. Now for Sean Burr. They play it in. It comes in front. And Kontos knocked it down. Kontos behind his goal. To Hartman. Can't clear it out. Red Wings putting on the pressure. Now Chambers in there. Takes a hit. And we get a whistle. And I believe the puck was knocked down with a high stick. And the faceoff will remain in the Tampa Bay end.
Well, there's a look at Tim Cheveldae. Cheveldae last year led all NHL goaltenders with 72 games played. He also had the most wins. He tied that with Kirk McLean with 38 of the Vancouver Canucks. And he played the most minutes last year, 4,236 minutes. Johnny's an avid sports collector of sports memorabilia. And there's a look at the big, tough guy, Bobby Probert. As you take a look here at an opportunity by Stevenson, he'll take the shot. And then he has good presence as he fell down and gave the pass back to his defenseman.
Quick shot off the draw, and J.C. Bergeron made the stop. We were talking to Pat Burns, the Toronto coach, the other night about Bergeron. And he said that Bergeron, he liked him quite a bit as he stopped McCrimmon here. When Burns was in Montreal, he tried to get Montreal to keep him. Instead, they kept Rasico, their current backup, but Pat said he liked Bergeron better.
Bergeron has really filled in very well here for this hockey club. 5 wins, 3 of them been on the road.
And a Fedorov shot is up high. Maybe one of the reasons they didn't listen to Pat Burns is he was let go shortly thereafter.
There's a look at Dallas Drake, a native of Trail, British Columbia. He was not supposed to make this hockey club this year. He played in Northern Michigan for 4 years under my younger brother. And Drake, who was on a 1991 national championship with the Northern Michigan Wildcats hockey team, had an outstanding year, an All-American last year, John. And he was the top defensive player of the year in the WCHA and also scored over 90 points. So he's been a pleasant surprise here for Brian Murray and staff.
And they like his feistiness as well. And he's got great speed, a good-looking young player. One goal for the Lightning. It's 2-1 Detroit. 15.5 minutes left here in the second. Now big McRae to center. Long slap shot, and Cheveldae handles that. Mark Howe in deep for Detroit. He gets it out. Yzerman works it in. As the Red Wings go in there forechecking. Bergeron plays it around the boards. Tucker missed it, but now Doug Crosspin gets it. Trying to clear it. But it's kept in there. Fedorov held it in. Now Yzerman behind the goal. And they put it on top of the mesh. And it's on top of the goal there on the netting. And that draws a whistle.
You can see Dallas Drake trying to knock the puck off. As you look at Doug Crossman, who played last year here with this Detroit Red Wing Hockey Club, Crossman leads all defensemen scorers with 7 goals and 20 assists for 27 points. Terry Christensen's been pleased and probably pleasantly surprised also by Crossman's point production. Doug has played over 13 years in the National Hockey League. He does get sat once in a while because he is one of the veteran players, as Rob Ramage is being sit tonight. Or sat tonight because he feels that it's important in this long road trip to rest some of the older players and keep their stamina.
Carson on a faceoff here for Detroit against Casper, number 11. He gets it. Red Wings up by 1. 5 minutes gone in the second. A Probert shot is wide. Now Carson after it. In the corner for Sheppard to Probert. Can't get a shot. And Bergeron flips it ahead. And the puck picked up by Steve Casper. Lost it. Now Zaminer grabs it for Tampa Bay. Casper can't work in. Here's Mark Bergevin firing it right back down there. And Probert plays it. Good pass for Chase on it. Center Zaminer broke it up. Rob Zaminer in there. Good pass to Casper in front. And he can't get a shot. Konstantinov for Detroit leads a rush. He was bumped by Bergevin. And Zaminer plays it off the boards back to center ice. Probert gets it. He just dumps it in. Bergevin with Carson on him. Good job by Bergevin. Near side. Iversen kept it in, but Beers is there. And Beers gets it off the stick of Bradley to center ice. Now the Red Wings turn it back in. Oh, 4-on-2 here. Gallant into Sheppard, and he missed the pass. What a chance there. Now Mark Howe in front to Carson, broken up. And now the Lightning work away. McRae ahead. Pass to Bradley, just missed. Now it's picked up by Bergevin. He carries in. McRae and Racine go to the board. Carson back there, but Bradley in there for the Lightning, stole it. Looks to center it. Here's Bradley now on the boards. Looks for some help. But the Red Wings get it back to center ice. Bradley bumped again at center ice. Now Dino Ciccarelli, he has a goal for Yzerman. Pass in for Gallant. But Chambers there to break it up, and John Tucker gets it back to center ice. 7 minutes gone by in the second period. The Red Wings lead 2-1. The next goal, very important. Now Yzerman races in. A shot and a pad saved by Bergeron. They center one, but Chambers stayed home, and he plays it down the ice. Chevalier leaves it for Racine. His pass tipped away. Now Taglinetti there for the Lightning. Kontos missed it. And Lidstrom brings it right back into Primo. He was checked, and Kontos a rush. 2-on-1 here with Creighton. Here they come. Creighton right in. A shot by Hartman. He scores! Mike Hartman, the native of Detroit, comes home and scores the goal to make it 2-2.
Well, there's a happy camper, and Mike Hartman, number 23, scoring a goal in front of his father and family here on the turnover. Watch it right here. A good deflection, or poke check, I should say, and watch the nice play by Kontos and Creighton on the 2-on-1. Hartman coming up late. It looked like Creighton was going to pass it to Kontos going to the net, but there's Mike Hartman. A good, quick wrist shot up high. Beat Chevalier for his second goal to tie this game up at 2. A great shot by number 23, Mike Hartman. But John, you know what I liked about that play? It was Creighton looked off Kontos, who went to the net, and left Hartman, the backup guy, gave him the pass and left him a wide open net.
Hartman gets it, his second, from Creighton and Kontos at 7:34. Hartman got his first goal in Los Angeles a week ago tonight. And he gets number 2 here to tie it at 2. Now Malte ahead, 3-on-2. In for Stevenson. Back to Malte, over skates it. And the Red Wings get it back to center. Sean Burr can't work ahead. Now Burr carries in there for Detroit. Here's Burr back on the point to Howe. Howe, a quick shot. That was blocked by Crossman. Now they play it back to the other side, but Malte there for the Lightning. That's Senator Rieke now ahead to Anderson. Here's Mikhail Anderson in there. can't get a shot off. Now the puck loose there. Stevenson can't center it. Red Wings get it near the line, and the puck slides to center. Now picked up by Beers. It's 2-2, 11:25 left in the second. Now Joe Riecke. He sends it in. Zaminer is after it, but Howe plays it to Fedorov, and the Red Wings look to set up. Fedorov now for McCrimmon. He'll play it down the ice. Bob Beers for Tampa Bay. In there, forechecking is Izobardi, gets it to Fedorov. In front, a shot wide. Now behind the goal. It's the rookie Drake. Drake in front, but Rob Zaminer, good defensive cover, broke it up. He feeds Danton Cole, another native of Detroit. Now Cole in there with Creighton. Cole goes wide in front, and Creighton can't get to it. Kept in by Zaminer on the far side. But the Red Wings come over and clear it away. Now Beers for Cole, right back in there. Whoops it in front. And Konstantinov for the Red Wings. Fedorov gets it out. Now Chiasson works in there. Far side. Drake takes a hit behind the goal by Chambers. And Bradley feeds Cole. And he'll get a faceoff here as he ices the puck. And Konstantinov going back. And icing called here against the Lightning. So Hartman's goal at 7:34 has tied the game.
Here's the turnover by Chambers that creates a scoring opportunity and eventually a goal here as the puck was lost. And watch the play by Kontos. There's the trailer. Hartman coming up late on the play, looking for the puck. A great pass by Adam Creighton, and Hartman just roofs this baby. And John, his father is the photographer here, and he said to me before, he was always nervous. There's a fine play, defensive play by Adam Creighton. He was always nervous when he came here, but tonight he says he felt very relaxed, and he was on that shot.
Red Wings center it, but Bergeron swept it away. Now Gerard Gallant gets it in a 2-2 game. 10 minutes left in the second. Now they center it. Gallant hit the crossbar. Oh, Gallant, what a chance there. Back is Bradley with Tucker. They can't work in. And now it's offside as Tucker touches that puck. Oh, Bergeron got a break there from his best friend, the goalpost.
Well, J.C. Bergeron standing strong as Gallant took the shot right from the slot area, and this went up high. Bergeron, I think, got a piece of that, John. It looked like when the shot was taken, it was coming. He was coming out of it. Hit him in the shoulder or crossbar area, not sure. But could have been dinged off either one, but it was awfully close. You're right.
Now the Lightning, McCray in front. Tucker, great chance, and shoveled a pad save. What a chance there. Now Ciccarelli back. It's still 2-2. 9:25 left in the second. That Lightning goal again. Hartman from Creighton and Kontos at 7:34. Bradley in there for the Lightning. Can't center it. And the puck worked ahead by Gallant for Iserman. Chambers broke it up. And Ryan Bradley now for Tampa Bay. Here he comes. Bradley, great move. In alone. Bradley right in. A shot. Saved by Chevalier. Now Bradley looks to center it. After some great moves. Red Wings clear it. Ciccarelli can't get it out. Bradley again. In front. But cleared away by Gallant. And it goes down the ice. And Bergeron will play it here, but Ciccarelli knocked it down. He's drilled down, though, by Taglinetti. A great play. And the puck cleared to center. Mike Hartman now for Creighton. Into Hartman again. Here he comes. And he fanned on the shot. But Creighton kept it in. Hartman a long shot. And Chevalier handles that. Good forechecking by this line. Hartman again centers it. No one is there. Crossman kept it in. Hartman another chance. Big save by Chevalier on Hartman. And then Creighton is drilled down by Probert. But Creighton gets up. Kontos a shot. And that was wide. And this line has come alive. Hartman in deep. Looks to center it. Gets it again. Hartman now trying to walk in front. A shot. And a save by Chevalier. Now Hartman pokes it in behind the goal. And Carson there for Detroit. It's 2-2. Just under 8 minutes left in the second.
Great effort there by the Hartman, Kontos, and Creighton line. The two playmaking players, Creighton and Kontos, working well with the mucker, Mike Hartman.
Now Zaminer drop pass. Cole gets it, a shot, and that's off a leg. Kasper plays it behind the goal. Zaminer centers it. Loose puck, and now Chevalier grabs it, and he holds it after some intense pressure by the Lightning. And we'll be back after this from Great Western Bank.
Ryan Bradley gives the old how do you do to Yves Racine inside outside and just misses on a good chance here on the backhand as Racine hooks him a little bit, maybe a penalty there, and then a good opportunity here for Mike Hartman with a good wrist shot. Hartman always had that strong wrist shot but hasn't used it that much. A good save by Chevalier.
Hartman has scored here in the second to tie the game at 2. 7:15 to go in the period. And the Lightning coming on here. Now Casper, Cole, and Zamen are up front. But the Red Wings get it back to center ice. As Drake looks to carry in, he does, centers it. Bergeron knocked it away. Now Drake hit by Doug Crossman. Paul Izobart gets it. Now for Fedorov. Wrist shot, and that never got through. Now the puck in front. Casper has his man tied up, but Fedorov gets it again. He's slick in front. Izobart can't get a shot. And a good play by Cole to knock a man down. And the puck held under the pile long enough, and we get a whistle. Well, don't miss Times Night on January 16th when the Lightning come home to take on St. Louis. Be there early to receive your St. Petersburg Times rowdy towel this Saturday against St. Louis.
Well, John, these last two games against these two combatants were some big goals, as you see, 10-5 and 9-7. What a coach's nightmare, and what a goaltender's nightmare. Could we be there again tonight with a score 2-2 midway through this second period?
Well, we're a long way from 15 or 16 goals, but with this Detroit team, they have scored 184 goals this year. They can pump them in. It's 2-2. There you see the time, 6:37 left in the second period. Another jam-packed crowd. Their average attendance here, 19,670. That's average.
And they've done that for 232 of their last 234 games, John. That's an outstanding record when you think of the number of people that come to watch this hockey club right down below us, the Detroit Red Wings.
No wonder Mike Ilitch was able to afford the Tigers.
And Sisson Fielder.
That's right. Of course, Ilitch, the owner of the Red Wings, and now the Detroit Tigers. Now Cicerelli in there. He's bumped by Stevenson. Stevenson, who sat out the other night, knocked down behind his goal. And then he fell on the puck. And we get a face-off. And then Stevenson gives Cicerelli a bit of a shot. And they both could go.
There's a look at Steve Yzerman, who be representing his hockey club in the 7th All-Star game in his career. As you look at Shane Stevenson, who's played a very strong game here tonight, John. He's a good skater. He just has not had that opportunity to perform in the National Hockey League. And he's getting it here with Terry Crisp. You look again at Yzerman and Stevie from Cranbrook, British Columbia. He's 13th in the NHL scoring. John, he became the youngest captain, 21 years old, here for the Detroit Red Wings. I played with Stevie when he came to this hockey club. He's the type of player that listened to every one of the veterans on that team. We had Brad Park, Ron Duguay was there also, and he's a good listener and a good learner, a quick learner, and you can see by his statistics that he's certainly performed for this team.
And he's had 5 straight 100-point seasons, but he's never been named to a season-ending All-Star team. He's played in the All-Star game 7 times, but never a first or second All-Star. Now the Red Wings in a 2-2 game. Cicerelli for Burr. Looks to center it for Cicerelli. He'll walk in front. Now a shot by Racine, and Bergeron handles that. As Yzerman lost his helmet that time.
And you can see Cicerelli not too happy, looking for the penalty caller, but some good defensive play and good defensive coverage by the defenseman here for this hockey club. Wayne Cashman, watching here, the move out in front, and he'll be pulled down there by Casper. He's helping out his defenseman. Good communication by the centerman and the defenseman. Cashman talked about the fact that this hockey club has been giving up too many second and third rebounds, as we saw a lot of that in Toronto. They want to tighten up that area in front of Mr. Bergeron, and they've been doing a very good job of that here in this second period. And And there's looking, the assistant coach, Wayne Cashman, looking very dapper tonight in his navy blue along with Mr. Crisp.
Wayne was one of the toughest to ever play this game, 18 years in Boston. He gave Mr. Esposito a lot of room in Boston.
Much like Basil McRae is doing now for Brian Bradley. And he works the defense corps. You see him there talking with him. He's always on top of them, mentioning, you know, keep an eye on this player or that player. And his players love to work under Wayne Cashman. He's a real player's coach.
And he does change the defense. Terry Crisp changes the forwards. That's how they work in concert behind the Lightning bench. And the Lightning, one of few teams with only two coaches. It's 2-2, 5:25 left in the second. Now Tucker ahead into Adam Creighton, can't work in. And the Red Wings, Ciccarelli. Now for Bird, drop pass, Yzerman to Ciccarelli, high shot, and a shoulder save by J.C. Bergeron. Yzerman to Bird in front, lost it, and Kontos gets it out. After some great chances by the Red Wings. Now Adam Creighton knocks it down into Kontos. Long slap shot and a shoulder save by Chevalier. Kontos takes Howe to the boards. Then Berg kicks it behind his goal. Creighton is in there. Try to center one. Get some help from Hartman. He has a goal tonight. Red Wings. Carson in there. This Carson line has been outplayed by Creighton's line. But now Howe works ahead. It's 2-2. 4:35. Oh, Chambers took that one high. And he goes down, and you hate to see that, as that puck was hit very high, and Gordie Hurlbut, the trainer of the Lightning, will attend quickly to Chambers. And Danny, this is the third Lightning player to be cut by a stick or a puck on this road trip.
Well, Mark Howe was trying to dump this puck in, and he fired it, got up on in, and went right off of Chambers' mouth area, and that's smart as Chambers heads off.
That is tough. Well, we'll have some fun this weekend as the Blues come to town to begin a seven-game homestand for Tampa Bay. Sunday, Washington in town, and both games can be seen here on Sunshine Network. The pregame show begins at 7 o'clock and the play-by-play at 7:30 both nights.
J.C. Bergeron making a big save, as you'll see the fan on that shot there by Burr, and then there's the shot by Ciccarelli. But what a nice save by J.C. Bergeron. Ciccarelli, John, has scored 461 career goals.
Here's a Tucker drive, and that's off the side of the goal. Now Bradley in deep for the Lightning. Can't center it. Tucker fireside. It's 2-2. 4:20 left in this second. Now Bob Beers, and that drive is partially blocked. And Chiasson gets it out. Taglinetti knocked it down for Tucker into Bradley. He's shifty. Can't make a move. Puck comes outside the line. Now the Red Wings pick it up. And here comes Carson, 2-on-2. Into Shepard. And that pass just over his stick. Now in the corner. Probert gets it. He'll walk in front. Pad saved by Bergeron. As Probert had a pretty good chance. And we get a whistle. It's 2-2 here in Detroit. More after this from the Olive Garden Italian restaurant.
Brian Bradley picks up his defenseman, or I should say plays a defensive position here on Carson. But look at the play here by Probert coming out, getting a bad angle shot. You don't mind giving up those, John. Good defensive zone coverage.
It's still 2-2, 3:45 left in the second period. Red Wings center it again, but Bergeron grabbed it. Detroit led 2-1 after one. Ciccarelli and Fedorov. Tucker scored for the Lightning. Hartman has scored here in the second as the Lightning have outshot Tampa Bay in this period.
You take a look at Doug Crossman with the face shield. That one wouldn't have helped Sean Chambers as he caught it underneath in the chin area in the lower lip, and that one's smart.
And he is getting repaired. We'll try and get a report from downstairs. Now Mikael Anderson gets it out. Then it comes back to Yves Racine. That pass bounces down the ice, and Mikael Anderson for the Lightning. He leaves it off for Mark Bergevin, now Rieke ahead to Anderson for Zaminer. He'll dump it in. And Racine again for the Red Wings. 3 minutes left here in the second period. Now at center ice, Fedorov into Eisenbart. Pulls up, left it. Fedorov gets it in front of shot, and that hit the side of the goal. Now back on the point. Racine, a wrist shot. Hop a leg and wide. Fedorov in the corner. Tied up. Puck comes loose. Cleared by Rieke one time, now a second time. And Rob Zaminer for Cole off his stick. And Racine, a pass. Drake the rookie gave it away. Red Wings take over again. In comes Racine. Drop pass, Eisenbart, and Rieke a block. And a big block at that. Here's a lead pass to Zaminer. One man back. Zaminer, great pass to Cole. Right in. Cole a shot, and he didn't shoot it. What a chance, and Cole never pulled the trigger. And now Cummins on the ice for Detroit. To Steve Yzerman. He flips it ahead. Taglinetti knocked it down and then was knocked down by Cummins. It's still 2-2, 2 minutes left. Here's a Beers pass into Kontos. Can't work across the Red Wing defense. Back is Yzerman. And Bergeron sets it up. Taglinetti, his pass now picked up by Adam Creighton. This has been the hot line in this period. Creighton now into Malte. Malte, great move in there. A shot and a save by Chevalier with his stick. And the puck flipped ahead. Taglinetti to Malte. Lost it. Now it comes ahead to Cummins. He gave it away. Malte again. Tied up by Konstantinov. And the Red Wings shoot it down the ice. Yzerman after it. Yzerman along the boards. Kontos knocked it away. And he flipped it over the glass. And we get a whistle. Let's go downstairs to Paul Kennedy.
Thank you very much, John. Sean Chambers, the Tampa Bay Lightning defenseman, injured on this play when the puck caught him flush in the chin. Right now, trainer Skip Thayer is attending to him, and Skip told me moments ago he's taking some stitches and is expected to return. Returning home tonight to his native Detroit, Mike Hartman has registered his 40th career goal to tie us at 2-2. Mike will join us and we'll chat too with Tony Esposito, recently returned from the World Juniors, played in Sweden. And of course, we'll update you on the other scores tonight in the NHL, John and Danny.
All right, Paul, thank you very much. We're live here at Joe Louis Arena in Detroit. Now Bradley with a minute left here in the second. And that play was offside. And we'll get a faceoff again.
There's a look at number 19, Brian Bradley, who is the Lightning's representative to the Campbell Conference All-Star, his very first. Brian Bradley is 6 goals away from tying Gilbert Perreault's expansion record of 38 goals. Perreault did that in 1970-71 with the Buffalo Sabres. So Bradley having an outstanding year and maybe even an opportunity, John, for a 50-goal season.
Now a minute left here in the second. It's 2-2. As the Red Wings get the puck to center ice. This is Sergei Fedorov. He's got great speed and great moves. Had it poked away, though, by Bradley. And now John Tucker ahead with McRae. Bradley follows up. Tucker gets it into the corner. Bradley is there. Drilled against the boards by Drake. Bradley stays on it now to McRae. Tucker parked in front. Now McRae pulled down and a penalty called here against the Red Wings. And finally, Magoo calls one the other way.
Now the first penalty, and this will go to Lidstrom for knocking down big Basil McRae to the right of Timmy Chevalier, and there's Lidstrom there skating to the penalty box. He'll get it for holding. As you mentioned, John, the first penalty against this hockey club tonight, the Detroit Red Wings. Watch McRae here. He'll get held here by Lidstrom and then pulled down. And talking with Basil McRae tonight before the game, he said his back and his groin have been bothering him, especially on the right side, because he sometimes overcompensates because of his weakness still on his left leg. And maybe not developed enough, so he sometimes pushes too hard with the right side than the left.
Lidstrom off for holding. Well, Lightning fans, don't miss Sports Unlimited night on January 17th, the winner of a fabulous cruise vacation. And now the Lightning have scored. right off the draw. There will it count. Tucker was there. And I think the Lightning have taken a 2 or 3-2 lead.
Well, you know what? Mike Magoo is now going to maybe take a look at this on the video replay. The shot was from the point, and 2 or 3 Lightning in front. McRae was out in front as well as Tucker. You'll see the play here set up by Bradley. Watch the shot here by Bobby Beers. There's the wrist shot. It is being reviewed, and they're probably going to see if anybody was in the crease, but no one was in the crease. That should be a goal, John, as it was knocked down, I believe, in front by either Tucker or a Red Wing defenseman. Everybody is down in front. They're looking to see if it's above the waist. You have to be above the shoulder. It might have been Basil McRae, too, that tipped it, but it was below his shoulder. You have to have the stick below the shoulder. If it's above the shoulder, then it's not allowed as a goal. It's definitely below the shoulder.
Well, Magoo will confer with the off-ice official here, and they will look at this on video. And if we can get a look at this again, the puck was shot high. It has to be, the stick has got to be below your shoulders. And let's take another look. This is our best angle, Danny.
It'll hit McRae's stick, I believe, right there. And you can see it's below his shoulders, probably about chest high level. That should be definitely a goal, John.
Well, the video says it wasn't above
the
shoulders.
Here's another look at it, John. But take a look at it as he, in slow motion here. McRae will put his stick up right there and tip it down. Now look where, and even Tucker's is below his waist also. So I don't see why the hesitation here on the video.
Well, we think it should be a goal. We'll see if the off-ice official. Let's try another angle. McRae, I believe, is the one who touches it. And that stick was chest high and no higher. And they will look at this at all angles.
I think they're going to, they have to call this a goal. He's, is he motioning towards the center ice? I believe it is a goal, John.
Well, a power play goal. And the official says yes. Dave Lewis, the Red Wing coach, doesn't like it. A big goal. We believe McRae will get it. A power play goal. And the Lightning have their second lead. It's now 3-2.
And this happened quickly. They're giving the goal to Tucker. That may change. Second, oh, they've given it to McRae. You're right, they have made the change. So McRae will get the goal from Bradley and Beers.
19:39 the time. That time running out here. Eiserman works in. He was knocked down. And time will expire in the second. And away from the play, Konstantinov and Cole get their sticks up. And everybody comes together. The second period is history in Detroit. And the late power play goal by McRae, his third of the year, third on this road trip. At 19:39, Bradley and Beers assist, and the Lightning have a 3-2 lead after two periods. We'll be back with our second period intermission right after these important messages. We are back live here at Joe Louis Arena in Detroit, Michigan. After two periods of play, the Lightning with a 3-2 lead over the homestanding Red Wings. Both clubs are back on the ice. Let's review the scoring from the second. Hartman second at 7:34, tied the game at 2. And then John Tucker's power play goal at 19:39. Beers and Bradley assist, and it's 3-2 after 40 minutes of play. The stats brought to you by the Discover card. It pays to discover, the card that pays you back.
Well, the opportunities on that second period, opportunities. One of the things that the Lightning did do is get some power play goals. As we look at this long road trip, the 9 games, look at all the different It's 57 meals, John, all the different hotels, the nine they had to stay at, 20 airplane flights, three snowstorms, one monsoon, one postponement of a game, and six time zones. So this Lightning Hockey Club, give them credit for weathering the storm, so to speak, John, and winning here 3-2 in this third period.
Off the draw, Yzerman dumps it in. It has been a long journey indeed. Now the Red Wings keep it in. Yzerman in front, and a Cicerelli shot is blocked. Tagliani tries to clear it, and he does. It comes to center ice. Chiasson drills it right back in. We are underway with the third period. Oh, a bad pass by Tagliani. Look out, Yzerman! And he missed a wide open side set up by Gallant. Now Tagliani doesn't take a chance this time. And he'll get a whistle as he drives it down the ice. And icing called here on Tampa Bay.
John, here's another look at the second period statistics. The faceoffs have been dominated by the Red Wings, but I mentioned the power play opportunities, a goal for each team, I should say. Turnovers more so on the Detroit side, and that's where the Lightning have capitalized on a couple of those turnovers.
By the way, they are continuing to work on Sean Chambers. He was cut in the lip area on a Mark Howe shot in the second period. He is getting stitched up and he could return. It's 3-2 for Tampa Bay. Early in this third, now Creighton gets the puck to center ice. With Casper and Cole. Cole after it, centers it, but Cheveldayknocked it away. And the Red Wings away. This is big. Probert, look out here, a shot! And Probert missed the goal by 3 feet. Cole tries to clear it. Probert kept it in. Now in the corner, Ray Shepard lost it, and Doug Crosman tries to work it ahead. Cole and Lidstrom fight for it. Probert near the line, a shot, and Zaminer blocked it. And the puck rolls down the ice. Iversen back for Detroit. The Red Wings' first round draft pick in 87. Now a steal here by Hartman. A drive and a stick save, or rather a toe save by CheveldayKontos fires it wide. And Shepard plays it off the boards and down the ice. It's on net. Bergeron handles it. It's still 3-2 for the Lightning. Kontos now a fight on the far side. Hartman and Bob Probert. Probert, some say the toughest in the game right now.
Well, Hartman's got to stay in tight on Probert. He's got a great reach and he loves to throw it when he gets separated. Mike is trying to stay in tight so Probert does not get that right arm loose, and Hartman's doing a real good job. He's very strong in tight, and that's all he's trying to do is tie up Probert. Probert's trying to get something going for his hockey club by taking on Hartman.
Well, they wrestle down, and a good job by Mike Hartman, a very good job, and Probert is really cut above the right eye.
I tell you, Mike Hartman, he took on Wendell Clark last game, and now Bob Probert, a couple of the premier fighters in the National Hockey League, give him full marks for this one. He's also picked up a goal. He had 3 shots in the second period, John, playing one of his better games in a Lightning uniform, and I'm sure his dad, who's in attendance, and his mom, who's watching this game on Sunshine Network in Florida, are enjoying his play tonight.
Well, Probert received a rather nasty gash above the right eye, and Magoo sends them both to the box. Here's how it all started. Probert is not cut now, so he was cut in this fight, Danny.
A good hit there, one by Hartman there. And you can see Hartman not letting Probert loose. There's a right coming up, but he ducks away from it. A pretty good scrap by Mike Hartman. Here's when they both go down here. And they both picked up 5 minutes, as you said, John, for fighting. And I'll bet you that Probert will be looking for Hartman when he gets back out on the ice.
Probert may have been cut when Hartman fell at the end of that fight. Or he could have been cut by a punch. Who knows? And now an icing call. The Red Wing player, Yzerman, or rather Drake,
yeah,
who is just getting up. fell down in there. And we'll get a faceoff back in the Red Wings zone.
There's a look at Steve Yzerman. Yzerman, their top point getter, with 60 points. John, it's interesting, up here in the booth, television booth on the, our opposite side here, is Mickey Redmond, a former Red Wing. The color on radio is Paul Woods, another former Red Wing, and Ron Duguay on our radio is a former Red Wing. So we have four former Red Wings up here in the booth, and Mickey Redmond would like to say hi to an old friend in and Red Wing fan, Howard Allison, who now lives in Tampa.
It's 3-2 for the Lightning. 2 minutes gone here in the third. Now Fedorov for Detroit checked. A pass into Mikael Anderson. Looks to center it, broken up by the Red Wings. And McCrimmon gets it out. Now Beers for the Lightning to Bergevin. Now for Kontos, they work it ahead into Creighton. Here's Creighton on his backhand. He's played a better game tonight. His line has been perhaps the Lightning's best. But Drake intercepts now for Fedorov. Howe can't work ahead, and Creighton right back in for the Lightning. Here's Creighton, spins around, and he's knocked down in front by Howe. And Drake gets it out. Good checking here by the Lightning. Anderson back for Doug Crossman. He played 2 years here in Detroit. Now for Rieke, ahead to Zaminer, too far. And Howe, number four, for Gallant. Just on the ice, Yzerman, he shoots it in. Gallant after it. Far side, Ciccarelli is there. Hit behind the net by Rieke. And the Lightning, who lead it by one, get it back to center ice. No icing here as Chiasson goes back. Chiasson now to center ice, Ciccarelli. In for Gallant with Yzerman. This is Gallant. Back to Konstantinov, a shot, and that hits Ciccarelli and went wide. Now Yzerman has Gallant in front. Yzerman right in front. Shoots, he scores! Yzerman! And it's 3-3.
Stevie Yzerman, his 32nd goal of the year. What a super play by the captain. Watch him come out from behind the net. Nobody takes him. They all leave him, and he just waits, 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 and throws it. What a great shot up high over the left shoulder of J.C. Bergeron. A perfect shot. But watch how he waits, waits. There's two defensemen laying down in front of the net. You've got to take Mr. Yzerman when he has opportunities like that in front of your goal.
Here's Ciccarelli, a shot! And Bergeron has that between his right arm and his body. So Yzerman has tied the game at 3:40 of the third, and we'll be right back here in Detroit. Well, Lightning fans, don't miss the Times night on January 16th, this Saturday, when the Lightning take on St. Louis. And be there early to receive your St. Petersburg Times Rowdy Tal. And after the game, a free concert. Nick and the Nice Guys, who have performed at the Super Bowl and the NHL All-Star Game, will be in concert after the game. Admission is free, and that should be fun following that game. A welcome back Lightning party featuring the group Nick and the Nice Guys.
And that should be a good night, John. I've seen this that band play before, and they're very good. And let's hope that they come up with a big win for a good party afterwards.
Well, Yzerman has tied the game from Ciccarelli and Konstantinov at 3:40 of the third. It's 3-3. Now Gallant tries to work in. McRae stole it for Kasper. And Kasper for Tampa Bay. Now for Beers. He fires it in. Loose puck poked away by the Red Wings. Ciccarelli. Beers fires it right back in. In front, McRae just missed it. Now Beers got it again. Into McRae. McRae, Bradley, and Tucker. Bradley in there looking for the loose puck. And it squirts free to Ciccarelli. And the Red Wings back. The always dangerous Ciccarelli scoops it in wide. And Bergeron gets it ahead to McRae. In a 3-3 game. Big Basil. Now Konstantinov there, trying to clear it, and it gets by Bergevin. And this is Riki back for Mark Bergevin. Now to Kontos. Long slap shot. Stick save by Shevelday. And the rebound cleared away by the Red Wings, Konstantinov. And now Kontos, number 16 for Riki, to Bradley. Brian Bradley just scoops it in. Shevelday will play it to the far side. Fedorov is there. Now ahead for Paul Izobart into the speedy Dallas Drake. In front, big save by Bergeron on Fedorov. He was wide open. Here's Kontos again. He can't get around Chiasson. What a save there by JC. Chiasson into Izobart, right in. A shot, he scores! Izobart, and it's 4-3 Detroit.
Paul Izobart getting a pass and sneaking in behind Peter Tagliavini here. Watch, it looked like he was going to shoot the puck, but decides to go to the net and somehow just gets it over the goal line. As Bergeron got a piece of it, he picks up the pass, sneaks in behind. Looked like he was going to shoot there, but decides to go in backhand. This one dribbles between the pads of J.C. Bergeron. Izobart's 17th goal puts the Red Wings up 4-3.
That goal comes at 5:47. So the Red Wings lead it 4-3. Now here's a pass into Malte. Malte centers it. Demeter drive. What a save by Shevelday on Demeter. Great opportunity there. And Carson now for Detroit. Izobart gets that last goal. Chiasson gets the assist. Then it's 4-3 Detroit. Demeter had that great chance. He was knocked down. And the puck squirts free. And Sean Burr will lift it high to center ice. Now Tagliavini. Off McRae's stick. Howe is back for the Red Wings. Up to Sean Burr. Now at center ice. Yzerman ahead. Works in there. Looks to center it. Pass across. Long shot by Racine Block. And McRae for Tampa Bay. Big Basil, long slap shot, and a pad save by Shevelday. Now it's cleared around the boards to Gallant. Gets it at center ice. Now into Cicerelli, broken up, and Brian Bradley for the Lightning. 12:45 left here in the third. The Red Wings up by one as Bradley works in. Still with it. Can't center it. Gets it back in there. Now near side, Bob Beers pinches in. Beers in there with Bradley. Now it comes in front, Tucker is there. Now Bradley grabs it, can't center it, and the Red Wings break it up. Steve Yzerman, 3-on-2 to Gallant. Still has it, in front, and no one is there, and the puck comes to center ice, and the Lightning goal came loose, and we get a face-off. We'll return after this from Gatorade. It's all you're thirsting for.
Some good work by Steve Malte here for the Lightning as they try to tie the score up at 4. Watch the backhand pass to Rob Zamner, who has not scored in 23 games, and he just blasts this one. Chevalier makes the save. Zamner has struggled, but as long as he's getting scoring chances, John, he will get goals.
Well, the Red Wings have two goals here in the third. Yzerman at 3:40. Izobart at 5:47 from Chiasson and McCrimmon, and the Red Wings lead by one. Long way to go there. Just under 12 minutes to play in the third. Peter Tagliavini for the Lightning. Off the boards. Kontos after it. Howe back there for the Red Wings, and Izobart drills Kasper to the boards. Now a steal in front, but Kasper can't get a shot. And McCrimmon for Detroit to Drake. Tagliavini took him out. And the puck grabbed by Kasper. Now ahead at center ice. Cole works in there. Long wrist shot. And it's gloved down by Tim Chevalier. And Fedorov flips it ahead. Joe Riki kept it in. Good play. Cole a shot. And that's wide. Now Kontos far side. Plays it in deep. Adam Creighton behind the net. Creighton looks for some help. Now it's drilled in there by Eisenbart. In there to help out Zaminer. He tries to work it in front, but Eisenbart picks it up for Detroit. Up the boards, Crossman kept it in, good play. Now far side, Joe Riki pinches in. He was drilled, and then a hit on Racine, I believe, on Riki, and he'll go off. And I think Tampa Bay will get a power play.
Well, roughing's a call on Racine as he retaliated and punched Joe Riki off the board. You'll see Riki come in, try to protect himself. He knows Racine's coming in there. He jumps away. Racine went right back after him and gives him a swat in the side of the head. Riki showing good composure as Mike Magoo, the referee, sends him to the penalty box. And I can't believe Racine's arguing that call.
Well, don't miss the Sports Unlimited night on January 17th. The winner of a fabulous cruise vacation provided by Sports Unlimited will be announced when the Lightning take on Washington Sunday, January 17th.
The second power play is the Lightning are 1-for-1 tonight on that Tucker goal. And with 10:42, John, a good opportunity to tie this game up.
The power play on this 9-game road trip, 7-of-45. Counting tonight. Bradley gets it back on the point for Beers. Long wrist shot. That never got through. Now Bradley on the boards. Into McCray. Big Basil back on the point to Beers. Now for McCray again. Right in. McCray to Tucker. And he can't get a shot. Red Wings clear it. And Beers again for the Lightning. Ian Crossman, the point man. Now Bradley for Crossman. Pass to John Tucker. Into the zone, but that play was offside.
There's Tucker, who's got 2 goals tonight. He got the last goal for the Lightning on the power play. A good deflection off of Beers. Bradley got the assist on that goal. Basil McCray skated to the penalty box to tell the scorekeeper that it was not here. His goal. Here's some upcoming games tickets. For the St. Louis game, there's still some available, as well as Washington. Capitals will be in town Sunday, Minnesota, and Toronto Tuesday and Thursday. So tickets are available at that number, 287-8844.
And it will be good to be home. 1:15 to go in the power play. Red Wings lead 4-3. Now McCray in across the Red Wing line. He lost it. 9:45 left in the third. Now Crossman back for Bob Beers. For Bradley. Ryan has 1 assist tonight. Now to Crossman. Tucker at center. Can't get it. Red Wings break it up. And Fedorov clears it away. Now 45 seconds left in Racine's minor. Crossman is back. Red Wings. Now they lose it. Here comes Tucker. Drop pass to Beers. Shot right on. A save. Puck loose there. Bradley after it. Tucker there as well. They can't get a shot, and the Red Wings clear it. Now Beers back in his own zone. 25 seconds left in the power play. Here's Beers into Mikael Anderson. Works in a shot, never got through. Anderson can't feed it in front, and the Red Wings get it out. Here's Beers, now to Doug Crossman. Checked by Drake, but Beers got back. And now it's center ice. It is Adam Creighton in. Racine is back on for Contos. Can't center it. And the Red Wings, who are at full strength. Here they come, led by Drake. Drop pass to Byrne. Out of Drake again. In front to Kromer, a shot. And that was just wide. And the puck cleared by Riki around the boards. Sean Byrne there kept it in. And then Creighton knocked a man down. Here's Drake, feeds it back, and it comes to center ice. 8:10 to go in the third. The Red Wings lead 4-3. Here's Joe Riki now for the Lightning. Long bouncer goes wide. Chevalier will clear it. And Bergevin kept it in. Long drive right on. Rebound, and Hartman is stopped. And a save as Probert and Hartman get their sticks up. And Probert could get a penalty here.
He cross-checked Mike Hartman in front of the net. Down went Hartman, and now Probert will go to the penalty box, and he is very upset with this call. High sticking will be the call on Bob Probert.
And a power play for the Lightning when we come back.
Lightning did not score on their last power play opportunity as Tucker sees the defenseman McCrimmon, looked like he was going to deflect his shot, drops it. Beers lets go of the shot, the save by Cheveldae, but now they have an opportunity as Mike Hartman, good poise and composure. Probert high sticks him there, but here's where he gets the penalty, right there. He knocks him on top of the helmet, and Probert off, Lightning on the power play.
Cross checking at 12:06, and the puck comes to Bergeron. Well, once again, don't miss the Sports Unlimited night on January 17th. The winner of a fabulous cruise vacation provided by Sports Unlimited will be announced when the Lightning take on the Caps Sunday the 17th.
John, I'd like to say hi to a couple Lightning watchers on the Sunshine Network, Mary and Earl Strader, who live in Cap Hayes, Florida, and their son is Dave Strader, who does the play-by-play for the Red Wings.
Big power play here. Tampa Bay down by one. 7:35 to go. Cheveldae tries to clear. Knocked down by Bradley. Bradley in for Tucker. He has two goals. Now Bradley gets it again. Feeds it in front. Here's a drive by Beers. Save. Puck loose. Cheveldae stopped it as Tucker couldn't jam it in. Now Bradley gets it again to Crossman. Crossman tries to center it. Heiserman grabs it. And it's cleared away now by Sean Bird. 1:10 to go in the power play. Beers right back to the Lightning. He'll work it in there. In for McRae, back to Crossman. Now to Beers on the point. In for Crossman again. Now Bradley gets it. For Doug Crossman back on the point. Here's Beers to Crossman. Now for Bradley, he missed it. Puck behind the goal. Kontos after it, got it. Now lost it, and the Red Wings will clear it. Fedorov ahead. For Izobart. He can't get a shot away. Now to Fedorov again. And he poked it toward the goal, but Bergeron knocked it away. Now 25 seconds left. And the Lightning power play. They're down by one. Crossman ahead. Pass into Mike Hartman. He was checked. Red Wings break it up. Shot in there, but Drake was upended. And the puck played down the ice. Chiasson will fire it down the ice again. And Probert is now back on. So the Red Wings still lead by one. 5:50 left. This is Bergevin. He was not flying. Probert gets it in the corner. He and Hartman collide. Watch those two. As McCrimmon gets it out. Knocked down at center ice by Kontos. And now grabbed by McCrimmon for the Red Wings. And he'll just play it down the ice. Now 5:25 to go in the third. It's 4-3 Detroit. They trail by one after two, but goals by Eiserman and Izobart have given the Wings a lead. Now an icing call coming up. Oh, and Hart Anderson took a nasty spill as he was going after that puck. That's how Al MacInnis of Calgary broke his hip earlier this year.
Oh, that's a tough play when you're fighting to get the puck to negate the icing. Anderson, who's a very quick skater, watch him go in, and he kind of loses his balance while going in there. I don't think Racine gave a little bit of a tug to the left on his left side, but down he went. No call against the Red Wings, John.
That's Phil Meir, the assistant coach of the Detroit Red Wings. He and Dave Lewis are running the bench tonight in Ryan Murray's absence. We're live at Joe Louis Arena here in Detroit, Michigan. 5:09 to go, and the Red Wings up by one.
And John, one of the areas that this team may lack at times is character. They've got lots of ability. It takes you to the top, but character usually keeps you there.
And you're speaking of Detroit.
Right, exactly. And the Detroit Red Wings have won 3 of the 5 Norris Division championships in the last 5 years.
But Norris Division championships have been fairly hollow the last 8 years. In the last 8 years, the Norris Division champion has advanced outside its division in the playoffs only twice. So there have been plenty of upsets in this division. Now the Wings, who lead by one. Shepherd fires it in. Bergeron gets it ahead, knocked down, a Shepherd shot. Rebound, Probert is there in front. Shepherd shoots, he scores! Shepherd makes it 5-3.
Ray Shepherd gets his 16th goal of the season on some nice passing from the corner. You'll see Big Bob Probert give it to Shepherd, and Shepherd with that great shot, that's the same place Yzerman beat Bergeron, up over the left shoulder. He just snaps this one, not much room, hits the two water bottles, and bingo, it's now 5-3 Wings.
Shepherd now with six goals in his last nine games. That's a tough one, and it's even tougher now for the Lightning to come back. They're down by two.
That one hurts, John.
We get a whistle here, and we'll take a break with the Red Wings ahead 5-3 here in the third. Welcome back to Jill Lewis Arena here in Detroit, Michigan. Over 19,000 on hand, and the Red Wings with a three-goal burst here in the third, lead it 5-3 with 4:19 to go. Here's a Gallant shot, that's wide. And McRae to Bradley. Now Rieke carries ahead, had a pass blocked. In comes Cicerelli. To Gallant, back to Cicerelli. And he can't get a shot. And Doug Crosman now for Tucker. That's center ice to McRae, but now they rule it was a high stick as Basil knocked the puck down with the stick above his shoulders. And that is a whistle.
Talked about McRae after breaking his leg in the second game of the year. And there's Mr. Probert, who has a little blood coming down his right side. And you can bet that Don Cherry just loves to see that. But Basil McRae, who still wears a removable cast on that left leg, it's a very light plastic, and then he puts his shin pad over top of it, has played very well in this seven-game road trip, John, picking up three goals. Two goals, I should say.
Detroit up 5-3. Here's a chance for Creighton, a shot, and a pad save by Chevalier. 3:45 to go, and the Red Wings just ice the puck here. And as Beers goes back, we get a whistle. Well, this one, it seemed to be in the Lightning's hands. But then Yzerman scored at 3:40, and that really gave Detroit a lot of life.
That one really hurt the Shepherd goal. Eisenbart goal put them ahead, John, as you mentioned, with the 17th. But the Shepherd goal puts them up two with only 3:36. The Lightning have been outshot 31-28 in this hockey game.
And they trail 5-3. Now Bradley on the faceoff against Fedorov. Fedorov gets it. Racine now for Probert. He lost it. And Beers back. Now to Bergevin for Beers again. Ahead to John Tucker. Tucker, Bradley, and now Creighton on the line. Pass in for Bradley. He cuts out of the corner. Tied up there by Lidstrom. Now Adam Creighton is after it. Two Red Wings on him. And Jimmy Carson digs it free. And here comes Carson into the zone, lost it. Tucker cleared it away. Creighton at center ice, can't get to it. And the Wings go back, McCrimmon in his own zone. Detroit up by two, late in the third. Now Probert, but Crosman stole it from him. Hartman there, can't clear it. Crosman does, to Hartman at center ice. He's had a big night. Hartman a long shot. That's well wide, and now Howe back in his own end. And he plays it too high, and it goes over the glass and out of play.
Mark Howe, who's playing
in his 17th pro season, John. He's 37 years old. As you take a look at the Lightning bench, there he is. His dad's number is retired here. Gordie Howe, who had 25 years, leads this organization with 1,687 points. His father, but Mark, last year played with a lot of injuries. He played in Philadelphia for 10 years. And in 1985-86, John, he was a plus 85, and his partner was Brad McKinnon with a plus 83. Outstanding in the plus minus category.
Now 2:20 left. Detroit ahead 5-3. Red Wings try and clear it. They do. And here they come. This is Drake carrying in. A shot! And an arm saved by Bergeron. And Tucker gets it near the line. Chris Kontos, he fires it back to center ice. Chase on there for Detroit. To Konstantinov. He dumps it in. Far side, Bradley steals it. And here come the Lightning. Time running out here, 1:45 to go. Now Bradley has some room in there. A drive and a pad saved by Chevalier as the Red Wing defense backed right in. Now Crossman back at center ice. To Mikhail Anderson. Anderson can't send McCray in. And Rieke grabs the puck. Here's Rieke in for Anderson. Lightning need one here. Drops it off. Creighton a shot. That was blocked. Now Creighton behind the goal. Can't wheel in front. And Cicerelli for Sean Burr. A minute 10 to go. Burr for Yzerman. In on right wing. A drive and a stick save by Bergeron. And Beers gets the puck. Now a minute to go. Beers back to center ice. Can't walk around the defense. Bergeron still in goal. Yzerman tips it by Rieke. Yzerman now for Burr. Sean Burr carries in. Bradley is on him. And the puck knocked in behind the goal. Detroit with a two-goal lead late here. Lightning try and get the puck up ice and maybe get the goalie pulled. Rieke fires it around the boards. Held in, Konstantinov, a shot. And that's off the side of the goal. 25 seconds left. Now Sean Burr in the corner. Back for Lidstrom. Finally, Bradley grabs it with 15 seconds to go. Brian Bradley all alone at center ice. Had it knocked away. Now Carson in, 5 seconds left. Shoots it wide. Konstantinov, a drive. That's wide, and the game is over. And the Red Wings snap the losing streak as they beat Tampa Bay 5-3 as the Lightning lose their last three games on this road trip and finish the trip with one victory and eight losses. So a tough loss here in the Motor City. The Red Wings win it 5-3. We'll be right back.
The NHL on Sunshine Network, featuring the Tampa Bay Lightning. And tonight's game live from Detroit has been brought to you by Great Western Bank and Great Western's family of companies, $38 billion strong. By Budweiser, the king of beers, who reminds you to please drink responsibly, because friends know when to say when. By the Olive Garden Italian restaurants, where all the best of Italy is yours. By Gatorade, it's all you're thirsting for. And by your local Gold Star Dodge dealer, get a great deal on a Dodge today. A trio of unanswered Red Ring goals in the third by Yzerman, Yzerbart, and Ray Shepard. The difference in this one, Detroit wins it 5-3 for the 24th win of the season. Time now to recognize our Great Western Bank three stars of the game, brought to you by Great Western Bank's family of companies, $38 billion strong. As you see, our number three star, Tim Chevalier, who stopped 26 of 29 shots on goal. Our number two star, John Tucker, this evening with a pair of goals, and Dino Cicerelli with a goal that tied it 1-1, along with an assist tonight, is our number one star. And here is Dino with his team down 1-0, 13:30 of the first period, from Stevie Yzerman and Gerard Gallant. The wraparound through the pads of J.C. Bergeron and Detroit would go on to win. Your final once again in the Joe Louis Sports Arena, 5-3 Red Wings. More in a moment here on Sunshine Network. Detroit collects its 50th and 51st point of the year, still in second place in the Norris as it beats the Lightning this evening, 5-3. Once again, inside the Joe Louis Arena, here's John Kelly and Danny Gear.
All right, Paul, thank you very much. A tough loss as this nine-game road trip comes to an end. The Lightning had a 3-2 lead after two, but then Yzerman tied the game, and then Paul Yzerman with the winning goal, and that is our Budweiser goal of the game here tonight from Joe Louis Arena, brought to you by Budweiser, the king of beers.
Yzerman picked this pass up along the boards from Chase on a good pass. Watch him sneak in behind the defenseman right there, Beers. And then he goes in. It looked like he was going to shoot, but see how far back in the net J.C. Bergeron is. You'd like to come out and challenge the skater, especially coming off the wing, but Yzerman did get the goal, and that is our Budweiser goal of the game.
And it was 5-3, a final. This road trip ends up one victory and eight losses. Not exactly great, as we all know, but remember, it's an expansion team. Things will get better. We're back home to start seven straight at home, and it'll be great to be back in Tampa.
Well, I'm sure fatigue probably set in a little bit in that third period. Give the Red Wings credit. They came after the Lightning, but Terry Crisp and crew are happy to go back to Tampa. They've got some home games coming up, and I know that they want to get back there and put some wins on the board, John.
Well, they battled hard. They were in every game except for a couple on this road trip. And a real tough loss tonight here in Detroit. That's the story from the booth. And let's go downstairs to Paul Kennedy once again.
Thank you very much, gentlemen. And the Lightning now with a record of 15 wins, 28 losses, a pair of ties, still at 32 points in the Norris. And for victorious Detroit, earning its 24th win of the year, now against 19 losses and three ties. And as we said, they are still hot on the heels of the Chicago Blackhawks. Let's update you on other action this evening around the National Hockey League on our Gatorade scoreboard, and you will see that Montreal leading 5-3 over Hartford. Muller, Desjardins, Skruland, and LeBeau now for Montreal. Washington with the lead. All-star Kelly Hatcher has a pair of goals for the Caps. They trail as the Rangers have rallied 5-3. Mikhail Pavonka with the goal as well for Washington, and Patrick Graves and Messier have helped New York storm back. It's St. Louis 2-1. Hall and Shanahan with the goals for the Blues. Glenn Anderson for Toronto. Winnipeg and Edmonton tied 1-1. And congratulations to Oilers rookie Brad Wawrinka with his first NHL goal. College basketball tomorrow night. The Hokies of Virginia Tech hosting UNCC live on Sunshine Network at 7:30. And then the Trojans of Southern Cal from the West Coast will visit Oregon State. And then a hockey weekend follows on Sunshine Network. Saturday night, Brett Hall and the St. Louis Blues in town to take on Brian Bradley. And then Sunday, it's Isle Iafaretti along with Kelly Hatcher and the Washington Capitals to tangle with the Tampa Bay Lightning. Your final this evening from the Joe in Detroit. There you go, the Red Wings, 5-3 over the Tampa Bay Lightning here on Sunshine Network.